Hello friends, I'm Nayashik from blog2.com and welcome to another amazing video. In this video, I'll teach you how to make the most professional and perfect listing and directory website using WordPress. I'll also teach you how to make money with this website using subscription packages and Google AdWords. For this website, I have taken inspiration from top listing and directory websites like Yelp.com, CitySearch and JustDial.com. Now let's see the demo website which we have created. So as you can see on your screen, this is the demo website. This is how your website will look. And this page which you see on your screen is a single listing page. This is not the home page. This is a single listing page, how a single listing will look like. Now, the reason why I'm showing you this page first is because this is the most important page. Okay, so let's see how it looks. So at the top, we have this beautiful line. If you could see this beautiful divider, colorful divider, blue color divider, light blue color. This is really looking beautiful. After that, we have some information like here we have our phone number and email address. Obviously, you can easily change this. I'll show you how to change that. Then here we have some social profiles, very good animation. And here it says 34 resources, which means we have 34 listing on this website. Now when you're logged in, you can easily add a new listing using this button. Okay, you just click on this button and you add a listing. After that, we have this nav bar. At the left hand side, we have this beautiful logo. And at the right hand side, we have our menus. We have only three columns over here and we have this beautiful thing over here. When you click on this thing, because I'm logged in, I'm getting these options to log out my account and my items. Now, when you're not logged in, when you're visiting this website for the first time, you'll see a new button, a different button over here which says login. And when you click on that button, it will ask you to register. We'll see that thing later on in a moment. Just stay tuned. After that, we have this beautiful map. As you can see, this is a really beautiful map. And we have different listings over here. For example, this is a listing. Now, because we are on this particular page, single listing, this is the listing on the map. When you click on this, you can see this listing name over here. This is the name of the listing. This is the address and this is the image. You can cut this thing. Now, when we are on the home page, if you see later on in this video, when we are on the home page, we'll see many different icons like this. But because we are on a single page, we are seeing a single listing over here. Then after this, we have this very, very useful and very beautiful thing over here. This map search bar over here. You can search for different places through using a keyword and you can search in particular category. For example, here we have different categories, cake and apps, pharmacy, laboratory, hospitals and so on. You can also search using some location. For example, you can search for some different location. And after that, we have the most beautiful feature. This is the geolocation feature, which means when you click on this button, it will automatically start tracking your location. Now, as you can see, this is tracking my location. Now, this is made possible using the SSL certificate. I'll show you how to install that and how to use that. Don't worry. Now I can set a radius. For example, I can set, maybe as you can see over here, when I change this thing, this number changes. So for example, I'm setting to 3.6 kilometer. Now when I click on this search button, it will show all the places that are near my location. As you can see, it has tracked my location and it is showing this radius over here. Okay, so this is really looking beautiful and this is working. But let's come back to the single listing and see how the single listing look like. So this was the header. And when we scroll down, you'll see over here, this is the name of the listing or the name of the restaurant, whatever it is. Here we have the rating. As you can see, it has got 4.5 rating. This is a subtitle. And at the right hand side, we have these different social icons and share this page text. Then we have these breadcrumbs. After that, we have these beautiful images. As you can see, when you click on this different things over here, you have different images. Now the user will upload all these images. I'll show you how a user can register to your website and upload their own listing. Okay, I'll show you that. Don't worry. I'll show you everything in this website. We'll see everything step by step. We won't miss any single step. I'll show you everything from scratch, from top to bottom. Okay, so don't worry, just see the demo website first. After that, you can decide whether you want to create a website like this or not. Okay, so this is how your images will look like. And if you see over here, we have different logos with different features. For example, here we have the car logo, and when we hover this, it says parking. Here we have the Wi-Fi logo, And when we hover this, it says free Wi-Fi. Now you can add many things over here, or the user can add many things over here. Now basically what it says that this place, this particular listing has got these features, and it is using this icon because just to beautify the website. Okay, so we are using this car logo just to show that we have parking facility. We are using this Wi-Fi logo just to show that we have free Wi-Fi. Okay, now after that we have some simple text. User can, you know, add this text. Then we have opening hours, as you can see, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, all the timings are given over here. Then we have address, locations, our address, GPS, the latitude and longitude, telephone number, email address and web address. Now you, it's all up to you whether you want to show this thing. Now you might want to just hide this thing. It's all up to you. You have total control on your website. Now after that we have two more buttons. Contact owner, when you click on this button, you can send, or the visitor can send a message to the contact owner or to the owner of the website. We have another button which says plan my route. Now I can plan my route from my particular location. Now it will show me all the steps, all the turns that I have to take to reach this place. Then after that we have this section. Now I purposely have created this section. As you can see, there is nothing to do with the memory, RAM and all these things. These all things are I have to do with a mobile phone, 64 GB RAM, color red and something like this. Okay, now I have just added it just to show you guys that you can add many different things. For example, it all depends on the kind of website you're creating. If you're creating a website for hotel listings, then you might need some different options over here, like dishes or something like that, I don't know. So you can add those options. I'll show you how to add custom options. Okay, according to your need, you can add custom options over here. Then after that we have this claim listing thing. So suppose someone else has submitted a listing and they don't actually own that. So the owner of the website can claim that listing. Okay, so we have this option as well. Now this is the map which is shown over here, the location of that person or the location of the listing. Then we have the review. Anyone can give a review, and we have different criteria for review. For example, they can give a different review for price, location, staff, services, food, and you can change these options. It's all up to you. And you can see these reviews over here. Then after that we have this thing in the bottom. Now this is also very beautiful and very useful thing. Now this is a special offer. Now sometimes when the user, when the person who has provided this listing, when they want to provide some special offer, they can, you know, add something like this, so that, you know, it will increase their chances of sales. And after that, if you see over here at the right hand side, we have this submit yours listing. Now because I'm automatically logged in, they have, you know, tracked that I'm logged in. If I'm not logged in, I'll get another option over here which will ask me either to log in or to register. So we'll see that thing later on. Now here we have another widget which says recent listing. Then we have recent comments and our locations. And at the bottom we have this beautiful footer. I'll also show you how to add this footer from here. Then at the bottom we have this copyright text and some different menu over here. Okay, so this was a single listing page. Now let's see how the home page looks like. Okay guys, so this is our home page. The top section is same, as you can see over here. We have the same information over here, same logo, everything is same, all this map and all. But here, as I said you earlier, now we have different listings over here. Now we are getting all the listings that are available in this particular area. We have medical clinics, we have laboratories, we have libraries and all these different things. Now this is the home page. The top section is same. After that we have this section. This is a slider, as you can see. Now this is different categories, for example food, healthcare and medicine, IT services. So this is all different category. When you click on this particular category, you'll see all the listings related to this category. And similarly, when you click on some different category, you'll see all the listings related to that particular category. Then after that, we have this thing over here, the best places. Okay, so we have sorted out some best places, or we have some featured places, featured listing over here. Now this is very useful because, as I said you earlier, that I'll show you how to earn money, real money, using this website. So one way of using, or one way of earning money through this website, can be using different subscriptions. For example, a user want to subscribe to your website and they want to add their listing. So for that you might have different plans, which I'll show you in a few moments. For that you can have different subscription. One can be a free subscription, and one can be a paid subscription, and the third one can be a professional or a business subscription. So this feature can be available in the professional or the business subscription, that, you know, when you apply for the top subscription, we will, you know, show your listing, or we will feature your listing on the homepage. So they will be ready to pay some more money. Okay, so you can easily earn money through that. And I'll show you how to accept payment using the credit card and debit card. So we can accept payment on our website. We don't have to redirect our visitor to PayPal or something. I'll show you how you can accept payment on your homepage, on your website. Okay, I'll show you that in a moment. Just stay tuned. After that, we have different location. Now, this is also a very similar section. Here we have different locations. When a person clicks on a single location, he'll see all the listings in that location. Then we have this widget. This is also a very useful widget. Now, this is all the special offers that is going on at present. You can see the date till which this offer exists. You can see everything. And when this person clicks on this, they will be redirected to that offer. Now, this is again a useful thing. You can give this feature, you can give this option to the top level subscription plan that you have on your website, so that in a user, when they want to, you know, offer some special offer, they can use this. And the person who are using different lower subscription level, they will not have this feature. It's all up to you. I'm just giving you a simple idea of how you can make some money using this website. Okay, then after that, we have these recent places. These are recent listings, and again, these are listings of the person who are using the top subscriptions. Okay, because we don't want to feature any listing of a person who is using a free subscription. Okay, because they are not paying, so they don't get extra services. And here also, if you see, this is looking really beautiful. We have this image over here, the title or the name of the listing, some description, the address, then we have the rating, their contact information, and this beautiful icon. Okay, because this is related to food industry, we have this icon. And one listing may, you know, relate to different kind of categories. For example, this one, this listing belongs to three different categories, like sports, travel and tourism, and so on. So you can have this thing as well. After this, we have a very simple section over here. You can create this section. I'll show you how to do that. Then we have packages subscription. Now, as I said you earlier, I'll show you how to do this. So we have three different packages: basic, premium and medium. And this is the featured package. You can set a package or a subscription package as a featured, and you'll see this. This is showing this star thing and everything is over here. I'll show you how to create this. This is creating this is really, really simple. Okay, now let's move on. After this, we have this last section which says, now if you want to register your website, just click on this button and they'll be redirected. I'm not redirecting them at present, but you can redirect them to the register page. I'll show you that in few moments. Then we have all our client information. If you have some big clients using your website, you can show their logo over here. That will, you know, increase the goodwill of your website. Okay guys, so this was our home page. Now if you don't want this header, if you don't want this map header, you can select some different header like this one. Okay, as you can see, this there is a beautiful image in the background, and we have this search bar. So if you don't want that map, I'll show you how you can get this thing as well. We have the search bar, and here also we have different categories. User can click on this icon, they have different categories. We have location as well, different locations, and we also have this geolocation, you know, that will track the user's location. So you can have this kind of header or this kind of page as well. So this was our home page. After that, we have the submit listing page. So this is the page where the user can submit their listing. So as you can see here, we have the title, register to submit your listings. Now if you see over here, I am already logged in, that's why I'm not seeing anything. Okay, but I'll show you how it looks in a moment. Okay, so first, if you see over here, there is some text over here, start promoting your business with us now. And we have how to join directory portal in 5 steps, fill in your email address and all these things. Okay, now here we have the recent listings that are done on our website. Then after that, we have frequently asked questions. Then we have the information about how many categories, how many locations, resources, reviews we have on our website. Now let me show you how this thing will look when a new visitor visits your website. Okay, guys, so this is how it will look when a person is visiting your website for the first time. They'll see this option, they can register up there, or if they have already registered, they can log in. Now, if they want to register, they can put in any username. Now, let me try any username. After that, they can put in an email address. Let us see. Okay, then they can select a plan, whatever plan they want. For example, they want professional. Then they can select the transfer method how they can use. So I am selecting credit card from here. Then they will click on I agree with terms and conditions. Then we have this captcha over here. They will just type in whatever they see over here. Then they can click on sign up button. Now as you can see, it is redirecting us to some different page. Now if you will see this pop-up over here, now this is how the user will make a payment. And now as you can see, for making a payment, they don't have to go to some different website. They can make a payment on the same website without going to another website. Let's make a payment. Okay, let's put a card number. Now I'm just putting some dummy card number. Okay, don't try this. Okay, now we can click on this button, pay $50. Now as you can see, the payment is successful. Now you'll get $50 in your bank account. So making money with this website is really, really easy. Now as you can see, user successfully registered. Email was sent to your email address. So one email address will be sent to that person's mailbox, and they can click on that link and they can complete the registration. We'll see that thing later on in this video. Okay, so this is how a user can submit their listing. Now let's see the contact us page. Now I'll also show you how to create a contact us page. This is just a bonus page so that you don't have to go to some different tutorial to see how to create a contact us page. Now this is also a very beautiful page. We have this beautiful image at the top. Okay, we have this our phone number, some good image over here, some information like a phone number, landline number, your social profiles, your map or your location. Then at the right hand side, we have this beautiful contact us form, very simple and very beautiful. And again, we have this facts over here, frequently asked questions. Okay, so this is a very short demo of the website that we are going to create. I hope you guys enjoyed the demo website. Now let's see how to register a domain name and how to get a hosting account. Now I strongly recommend you to watch the complete video, especially the hosting thing, because the hosting that we are going to use in this website is totally different. Okay, because here we have different options going on, like geolocation, and we also have different options like making payment on the same website. So for this, we need a different kind of website. If you're using some different hosting provider, you might not be able to use these features. Okay, the feature that will track the user's location, this feature is available only if you follow my step. And the next feature, that you a user can make payment on your own website without going to some third party website, this feature will also be available only if you follow my steps. Okay, if you don't follow my step, if you're using some different hosting account, if they don't have all the features required for all these features, then you might not get those things. Okay, so just stay tuned. In the next step, we'll see how to register a domain name and a hosting account. Welcome back, guys. So as I said you earlier, that to create a listing and directory website, we need a different kind of hosting account, a different kind of hosting provider. Because for this, we need a SSL certificate. As you can see, this is the SSL certificate, and we need a very fast and very reliable hosting provider. So for this kind of website, like e-commerce and listing websites, I recommend TMD Hosting. This is the best hosting provider for this kind of website, like e-commerce website, listing website, membership website, all these websites which require making payment on the website and using special features like geolocation and so on. For these kind of website, TMD is just the best. Now I'll also show you how you can get a discount on TMD, so don't worry. Just open a new tab and type in blogdude.com/TMD. Now this link is also given in the video description below. You can just click on that link and it will redirect you on this page. Now as you can see over here, it is giving some discount, but this discount is for simple shared hosting. We don't want this shared hosting. This is very, very slow. Okay, we want the cloud hosting option. So here you will see one option, one button which says get into the cloud now. Click on that button. Now when you do so, you'll see there are three different plans: Starter Cloud, Business Cloud and Enterprise Cloud. Now let's see what are the special features that is there on this hosting provider and why you should choose this hosting provider for your website, for your listing or your e-commerce website. So the first feature is that it has got 6 core CPUs. Now if you guys don't know what a hosting is or what a domain is, let me explain you that. First of all, is a domain name. Now both this thing, a hosting and a domain, is compulsory to create a website. Without these two basic things, you just cannot proceed further. You just cannot create a website without these two things. The first one is a domain name. Now it is nothing but the name of your website or the domain name or the URL of your website. For example, if you see over here, tmdhosting.com is a website name, and also if you see blogtoot.com is a website name or a domain name, google.com, youtube.com, these are all the domain names. So that is what a domain name is, and you can get a free domain name if you use this hosting provider. Then what is a hosting provider or what is a hosting account? Now all the data that is there on your website, for example, if you see our demo website, now we have this logo, we have different images, different codes and everything. Now all this data is saved somewhere on some computer which is running 24/7. Okay, so there is a computer which is running 24/7, and that computer has all your files that is stored on your website. So that whenever someone comes and visits your website, they can see the website live. That's why that computer is running 24/7. So that computer which has stored all your files has to be a very, very good computer. Only then your website will be more faster and the performance of your website will be good. Now, if you see over here, the computer which these guys are using, it has got 6 core CPUs, which is really, really amazing. Okay, 6 core CPU is really great. And after that, we also have 6 GB of DDR4 RAM. So which simply means that these guys are using a really good and reliable computer. After that, we have unlimited bandwidth. Now, this is also a very important feature. Now, what does this mean? This actually means the amount of data that you can transfer from your website, the amount of data that you can download, and the amount of data that you can upload to your website. So you can download unlimited amount of data from your website, and you can upload unlimited amount of data on your website. Now, this might look simple to you, but many few websites, there are very few hosting company that provide this feature. So this is really, really amazing. After that, we have SSD space. Now this is the most important feature that is provided by TMD Hosting. Now most of you guys must know this thing. This is a very simple thing. If you're familiar with computers, you know this thing, that SSD is way more faster than the regular HDD. Now most of the computers, most of the laptops and most of the hosting provider use the simple HDD just to save some money. Just they take same money, same amount of money from you, but they provide only simple and boring and slow HDD storage. Okay, now there is a lot of difference between HDD and SSD. If you don't know that, you can go to Google and type in SSD versus HDD web hosting. You can see the difference. There are many different articles written. You can, you know, read all of them to get a better idea, or you can just click on images and, you know, open the first result, or you can open any result. Everything is same. Now here you can see the difference between the regular HDD and the SSD that we are going to use on our website. Now the regular HDD, first, there are 3 different criteria over here. The first one is speed, and here it says higher is better. Obviously, the higher the speed of your website, the better it is. Now this green bar is SSD and this orange bar is HDD. Now you can see the green bar is way more higher and way more better than the HDD. Okay, so sometimes the speed of a website using SSD is 30 times faster than the speed of a website which is using the regular HDD. So this is a great thing. The second thing is IOPS. Again, it says higher is better, and you can see the difference over here. It is really tremendous amount of difference over here. And the third thing is latency. It says lower is better, and again you can see the difference. There is insane amount of difference between all these things. Okay, so this is just the best feature provided by this company. Not only that, it has provided us with SSD space, it is providing unlimited SSD space. Now there are few companies that do provide SSD space, but they provide a very limited amount. for example 10 GB, 20 GB, something like that. But here we are getting unlimited SSD space, which is really amazing, really crazy. After that, we have another amazing feature, which is unlimited website hosted. Now, what does this mean? This means that you can host unlimited amount of website on one single hosting plan. Now, today you're creating this website, this listing and directory website. Tomorrow, you might need to create a different website for your business or maybe an e-commerce website. So tomorrow, again, you don't have to purchase a new hosting plan, a new hosting account. You can just use the same hosting account and you can host unlimited amount of website on that. Okay, so this is also a very useful feature. Then after that, we have a free domain. As I said you earlier, we'll be getting a free domain with this account. Then we have premium support, very good support from TMD hosting, free cPanel, web server, wildcard SSL. Now, as I said you earlier, we'll be getting free SSL certificate. This is the SSL certificate. This green socket over here is the SSL certificate. And this is a must, okay? This feature is a must on this website. If you don't have this SSL certificate, you cannot use this geolocation. You cannot track the location of the visitor on your website. Also, if you don't have the SSL certificate, you cannot accept payment on your website. You will have to redirect the user to some different website to accept the payment, which is not a good idea. Okay. Now, not only that it has an SSL certificate, but it has wildcard SSL certificate, which means that you can have SSL certificates on unlimited number of domain names and subdomains. Now, one single SSL certificate costs around $50 to $100. So you're saving thousands of dollars over here. We also get optimum cache that improves the performance of our website. We have memory cache instance of 256 MB. Performance is 3 times better than these two plans, and we also get 60 days money back guarantee. Now you can choose any plan between these three plans. Now I don't recommend the starter cloud. The reason is very simple. Here you can host only one website. So suppose tomorrow if you want to create or if you want to host another website, you will again have to purchase a hosting account, which is not a good idea. I would recommend you to go with either with the business cloud or the enterprise cloud. Now I am at present using the enterprise cloud, and that's why I am recommending you guys to use this, because this is what I personally use. Okay, so I am going to sign up with the enterprise cloud because that is what I'm using. Just click on this get started button. Okay, once you do so, you will be redirected to this page. Here you have to enter the domain name which you want for free. So you can enter anything over here. For example, I can enter Nayashik1, and you can also select the extension from here. You have different extensions, .com, .net, .org. If you're creating a website for an organization, you can select .org. If you're creating a website for country specific, for example, if you're creating a website which will ask listing only from India, you can select .in. If you're creating this listing website only for UK, you can select .uk. But for most of you guys, I would recommend you to select .com. This is the most common and most reliable one. This is the most famous one which is used. Okay, so you can select any extension, any domain name from here and click on proceed. Now you have to put in some contact information, really basic information like your first name, last name, email address, phone number, company and so on. After that, you have to put in the payment information. If you want to make payment through credit card or debit card or your ATM card, you can select this option and you can put in the type of card, for example, Visa, MasterCard. And if you're an Indian and if you have a RuPay card is not accepted over here, because in India, most of the people today have RuPay card. Now that is only for India. If you want to make payment, you must have a Visa, MasterCard or, you know, these kind of cards. Only that in only then it will accept your payment. And if you can also make payment through PayPal, it's all up to you. Then after that, we have third option, which is purchase information. The first thing is to select your data center location. Now the one which you must select is the one which says nearest to you. For example, here, as you can see, Singapore says nearest to you. So I will select Singapore. Then we have period. Now by default, if you see 12 months is selected. Now I also recommend selecting 12 months. Don't ever select 1 month plan. Now the reason is very simple. If you select 1 month plan, you will have to pay $7 extra every single month. So by the end of the year, you're paying $70 to $80, in fact, around $100 extra. So that is not at all recommended. Select the 12 months plan. Then after that, we have domain privacy. If you want to protect your email address and your name, last name, first name, last name from anyone visiting your website, you can have this thing. Okay, so that no one can see who is the person who has registered the website. If you don't have any problem with anyone seeing who is the person who has registered the website, you can just untick this. Okay, or if you want to protect that, you can just tick mark this. It will cost you $10 per year. Okay. Now, after that, we have the most important feature, most important option. Why is this the most important option? Because this is the option that will save you some money. Now, here you have to enter Nayar 7, N-A-Y-Y-A-R and numeric 7. Now, this thing is also given in the video description below. You can copy that link, or you can copy that code from here and put it over here. Okay, the code is given in the video description below. Just put the code over here and click on apply. Now, as you can see, when we click on apply, it says this promo code gives you 7% off this purchase. And 7% is the highest discount that TMD offers on cloud hostings. So that is a great, great thing. Okay, you're getting the highest discount possible. Once you're done with everything, just tick mark over here, I agree to the TMD terms of service, and click on checkout. Once you click on that checkout button, you will receive a mail from TMD Hosting. Now, this is a very, very important mail because you have many important information like your FTP username, your password, your name server, and everything. These information are very crucial, very important. So make sure you save this information somewhere. If you have, you know, multiple email addresses, you can forward these to those different email addresses. Just do anything. Just make sure to save this information. Now here at the bottom, you will see a link which says control panel link. Open that link in a new tab. Now this will open the control panel over here. Now just enter the username and password from that mail and click on login. Okay guys, so this is our cPanel, and from here we can control everything, almost everything that we do on our website. So the first thing that we have to do is to install WordPress on our website. So go at the bottom under Softaculous app installer section, you'll see the first option is WordPress. Click on that. Now click on install now. Okay, now from here, select your domain name. Now, if you're creating your website for the first time, you'll see only one option over here, only one domain. But because I am using TMD for a very long period of time, and I have created hundreds of different websites using TMD, that's why I'm seeing, you know, I was seeing many different domains. But if you're doing this thing for the first time, you should see only the first domain which you entered on the first step, okay? Now, once you enter your domain name, make sure you have this. The protocol is HTTPS, okay, not the simple one. You have HTTP and you have HTTPS. So either select the third one or the fourth one, the one which HTTPS, okay, with the extension S. Just select that, and after that, the third box over here is in directory box, and here WP is already typed in. Just delete that WP. Now come back. Now here we have different option like your site name and site description. Put in your site name over here, and after that put in your site description. Your site name can be the name of the company, and the description is just a small description or very short description of your company or the tagline of your company. So put this thing over here, and then after that we have the most important option. Here we have to change the username and password of the dashboard of our website. So you can make sure you change this thing. It is very, very important. So put in any username and put in any password of your choice. So I'm just putting some password of my choice over here. Now after that, we have to change this email address and put in our own email address over here. So once you do all these changes, come at the bottom and click on install. Okay, so as you can see, WordPress is getting installed on our website. It will take few seconds, don't worry. As I said you, it took few seconds. Now we get two different links over here. The first one is your website link, and the second one is the dashboard or the administrative URL link. So let's open both the links in new tab. So first, this is the website. Now this is how your website will be looking. Okay. Now after that, we have the dashboard link. Let's open that link in a new tab. Okay guys, so this is our WordPress dashboard. This is the place from where we will create all the listing. We will control everything that happens on our website. Now first, if you're creating a website with WordPress for the first time, don't worry, using WordPress is really, really easy. And if you're following my tutorial, if you're following my steps, it will be more easier for you because I'll explain you everything in detail and I'll show you everything step by step. So just don't worry if you're doing this thing even for the first time. I'll show you everything step by step. Okay. So the first thing that we have to do is to do some important changes or some important settings. So to do so, at the left hand side, you'll see different options. From that option, you have the settings. Click on settings. Okay. Here you have the site name and site tagline. If you have not changed the site name and the description in the earlier step, you can change it from here. Then after that, we have the most important option, this option, membership option. Make sure this thing is tick mark. Anyone can register. This is a very, very, very important option. If you don't have this thing tick mark, no one can create a website on your website. Okay. No one can create an account on your website, which is really dangerous because we want users and different customers to create account on our website and to make payment and so on. So make sure this is tick mark. Okay. Now after that, just come at the bottom and click on save changes. Then from the left hand side, you will see under settings, there are different options. Click on permalinks, which is at the bottom. Now here by default, the day and name structure is selected, but we want a different permalink structure. So click at the bottom on this thing, custom structure. And you have some structure over here, just select that and delete it because we want something different. And from here, first click on this category and after that click on post name. Okay, so your custom structure should look something like this. First we have category, then we have the post name. Once you do so, just click on save changes. Okay, now let's come to our website. As you can see, this is how our website is looking at present. And this is looking very, very boring, very, very bad. Okay, this is not the website that we want. We want to create a beautiful website like this. So to do so, we need a theme. Now, if you don't know what is a theme is nothing but the design of the website. A theme is something which has all the different features and everything that will convert your boring website into something amazing like this. Okay. It is basically the design of your website. Now, this theme, which is already over here, the default theme, it has got this design, this boring design, but we want this beautiful design. As you see over here, we want the map. We want this map search form over here. We want all these things. So for that, we need to install a new theme. Now to install a theme, just click on appearances from the left hand side. Now if you see over here, we have already two themes installed. Now we don't want this. So just click on this and delete it. Now this is occupying unnecessary space, which we don't want. We want our website to be very clean and we want it to be very light. Now the next option is to add a new theme. But before adding a new theme, we have to do one more change. Now let me show you what is that change. From the left hand side, you have this media option, hover media, and click on add new. Now when you do so, you'll see at the bottom, it says maximum upload file size is 2 MB, which means that you can upload any file which is up to 2 MB on your website. If the file size exceeds 2 MB, you cannot upload that on your website. Now this is very bad because the theme that we want to upload is more than 2 MB. And if you want to upload any picture, any video, which is more than 2 MB, you cannot do that. So first we'll have to fix this thing. So to do so, we will use FileZilla. If you don't know how to use FileZilla, how to set up FileZilla, there is a video on my website, on my YouTube channel. You can watch that video. That will surely help you. I'll give a link to that video in the video description below. You'll find that link over there. Okay. So let's open FileZilla. Okay. So once you open FileZilla, you will see your website, a folder over here. For example, if you see my website name is BF1, which is Business Finder 1. bf1.nayashik.com. So let's search for that folder. As you can see here, it is bf1.nayashik.com. Open that folder. Now go to my website. In fact, you don't have to go to my website. I'll give this link directly in the video description below. Okay, let me see that. Okay, when I go to my website, there is a post. Let me search for that. Here it is. Solved, the upload file size exceeds, and so on. So this is the one which I have to use. Just click on this. Okay, now go at the bottom. I'll give this link in the video description below, so don't worry. Now if you go at the bottom, you have few lines of code over here, 5-6 lines of code. You have to copy this thing from here. Now again, come to FileZilla. And if you see on your website file, there is one file which says .htaccess. On your website folder, there is this file which says .htaccess. Now we have to drag this file on your desktop. So what you can do, you can come over here and select desktop from here and drag this file on your desktop. Just click on this, hold it and drag it over here. Okay. Now once you drag the file on your desktop, let me show that file. This is how your file will look like. This is the file. If you open this file, this is how it will look like. And if you're not able to open this file, there is a program called Sublime Text. It is a free program. It is a free program, very useful and very nice. You can download that. It will help you to open this file if you're not able to open that file. Okay. Now what you have to do, you have to go to this website and copy these lines of code and come to that file again. So here is the file and paste those lines over here. As you can see, I have pasted it. Now press Ctrl S to save this file. Now you can cut this thing. Now again, come to FileZilla and refresh this section, your desktop section. Okay. And drag this .htaccess file again to your website file. Okay. It will ask you to overwrite it. As you can see, it is asking you to overwrite it. Just select overwrite and click on OK. Now, as you can see, it says transfer finished. Now we can get rid of this. Again, come back to this page. Earlier, it was saying 2 MB. Let's refresh this. Now, as you can see, it is saying 64 MB. Now we can upload any file up to 64 MB, which is really cool. Now let's upload the theme that we want to upload. So click on appearances from the left hand side. Click on add new, upload theme. Let's choose the file. Okay, you first will have to download this file. So to download this file, let's get rid of this first. Open a new tab and type in blogdude.com/bf for business finder. Okay, blogdude.com/bf. Now this link is also given in the video description below. So don't worry, just go in the video description. Click on this link and you will be redirected to this page. Let me show you. Okay, once you click on that link, or once you go to blogdude.com/bf, you will be redirected to this page. And as you can see, this is the theme that we need. Okay, Business Finder Plus WordPress theme. Now this is a very, very beautiful theme. Now you can purchase this theme for just $69, or you can use the full membership plan over here. Now full membership is a very limited plan, very limited offer. You're getting this for $99. I think when you visit the website for the first time, from that time till 3 days, I guess you get this offer, that it is actually $225, but you're getting this for $99. So what I want you guys to do is not to purchase the single theme, but purchase the full membership. Because when you purchase this full membership, you get many different premium themes and plugins free with this plan, the full membership. And you also get many different extensions that we are going to use on our website. Okay. So if you purchase the single theme, then you will have to purchase different extensions again and again. Now that will, give you some more bigger bill if you will have to spend more money. So I don't recommend that. Just purchase a full membership. You'll get all the extensions for free, or everything for free. Let me show you what are the different themes available, premium themes. Now, as you can see, there are many different themes over here, like Business Finder, Directory Plus, Food Guide, Event Guide, and all these themes. Now, all these themes are premium themes. As you can see, $59, $69. Now, when you sign up for the full membership, you get all this theme, more than, I guess, 30, 40 themes. You get all these themes for free. Okay. So you don't have to purchase every single theme, and there are many different plugins as well, many different plugins, extensions. You get all these plugins and extensions for free as well. Now this is very important. For example, if you see this plugin claim listing, now this is a plugin which we'll be using in this particular tutorial. So if you purchase the full membership, you don't have to purchase anything else. Okay, everything will be there on your account, or else you will have to purchase everything one by one, which is not a good idea. Okay, there are many different things. For example, Stripe payment, we are going to use this as well. PayPal payment, we are going to use this as well. Special offers also we are going to use. So as you can see, if you go to purchase single thing, it will cost you a lot of money. Just go over here and join, click on this button, join to download, and sign up with this full membership plan. It will cost you around $99. You have all the premium themes, all the plugins, all the graphics. There are many different graphics available over here, so you can use those graphics as well. Okay, so if you want to join, just click on join today and fill up everything and purchase this theme. Now I won't do that because I have already done that. So I'll log in over here. I'll click on login, put in your email address, password, click on sign in. Now because I have already purchased the theme and all the extensions, I don't need to purchase that. As you can see, Business Finder Plus, this is the theme. Just click on this download button, it will start downloading. As you can see, now I'm canceling this because I already have this file. Okay, so we can just cut this thing now, and after that we have many. In fact, let's not cut it because we'll require more plugins over here. You have download plugins link over here. When you click on that plugin links, download plugin links, you have all the plugins over here. Now we'll be requiring all these things. Okay, first let's upload the theme. So let's click on choose file, and now choose the file that you just downloaded. Okay, so this is the file, the theme file which I just downloaded. Select this file, click on open. Now click on install. Now you can see the progress of this installation at the bottom left corner of your browser. If you're using Google Chrome, you can see that around 30-35% it's done. Now by the time it is getting installed, it is getting uploaded on your website, you can do few things that will take only few seconds, not even just one to two seconds. You can subscribe to my channel and click on that bell icon so that you don't miss any future updates. And I make only useful videos that helps you generate some money. Okay, so make sure you subscribe to my channel, click on that bell icon. If you appreciate my efforts, if you like the video, then give a thumbs up to this video. Also leave a comment, I would really appreciate that. And if you have any doubt, any queries, any suggestions for me, you can also put them in the comment section below. Okay, now as you can see, the theme is successfully installed. Now it's time to activate the theme. So just click on this link which says activate. Okay, fine. So once you're done, just click on continue. You'll see this option, this page. Click on continue. Okay guys, so it is done. Once you click on continue, you'll be redirected to this page. Now it took few seconds for me. In fact, it took around two minutes, I guess, to when I click on that continue button, it took around 2 minutes. Now if you see over here, it says new version is available. So whenever you see something like this, just make sure you update that and you update to the latest version. Okay, so let's see. Okay, it is not updating because first you'll have to enter all your credentials over here. So I will do that thing later on. First let's install all the plugins. So click on begin installing plugins, and here you have this plugin. Just click on install. Okay, now it says plugin installed successfully. Go to return to required plugin installer. Okay, we have revolution slider. We just have to activate this. Just click on activate. Fine, so everything is updated and activated. Now come back to this page and click on this download plugin button. Now from here we need few plugins. Now just start noting all the plugins that I'm saying. First plugin that we need is called Special Offer. Second, Stripe Payment. Third, PayPal Subscription. This is not compulsory, but if you want, if you have this thing for free, why not use it? Okay, fourth one, this is not required. If you want to make your website in different language or multi-language, you can use this, but this is not required. The fourth one is Item Extension. Fifth one is Claim Listing. Sixth one, get direction, and the seventh one is item reviews, and we also have 8th one, PayPal payments. Okay, so make sure you have all the 8 extension that I just mentioned and download everything. Just click on this button, it will download it for you. So once you download all the plugins, just come back to this website and hover this thing over your plugins and click on add new to add a new plugin. Now, if you don't know what a plugin is, if you are using WordPress for the first time, and if you don't know what a plugin is just a way to extend the functionality of your website. For example, let's take the same example which you are using at present. Now, this is special offer. By default, special offer, if you see this at the bottom, this is the special offer that a user can create. Okay, so by default, this functionality is not available on your website. Now, to add this functionality, to add this feature, we need an extension, a plugin that will enable us to do this. For example, when someone is creating an e-commerce website, they cannot create an e-commerce website with WordPress. If they want to create an e-commerce website with WordPress, they need an extension or a plugin called WooCommerce. Once they install that, it will expand the functionality of WordPress and they can install and create a e-commerce website. So that is basically what a plugin is. Now we have to start uploading the plugin one by one. So just click on this button, upload plugin, choose file, and here I have all the plugin files. So one by one, just select the first plugin, click on open, click on install now. Okay, it is successfully installed. Now click on activate plugin. Okay, as you can see, it is activated. Now again, click on add new, repeat the process and click on upload, choose file, select the second plugin, and similarly, you have to upload all the plugins one by one. Now it will take some time and I don't want to show you the same steps again. So I'll pause this video. I'll install all the plugins, then I'll come back. Okay guys, so as you can see, I have installed and activated all the plugins. Now come back to your website and let's refresh and let's see the changes that are taking place. Okay guys, so as you can see, now the website is looking much better. We have most of the things showing up over here, but we don't have this map showing up, because to show the map on your website, you first need a Google API key. So let me show you how you can get that. Let's cut this thing. Open a new tab and type in console.developers.google.com and make sure you have an account. If you don't have an account, it will take few seconds. Just create a new account. Okay, it is really, really simple. Now, once you create a new account, it will show something like this. You'll see a page something like this. Now, first we have to create a new project. So to create a new project, at the top, you'll see something like this. Click on this. Now click on this plus button to create a new project. Now you can name it anything. So let me name it maybe business finder plus. Let's name it, okay, we cannot use plus, so let's name it business finder. Now let's click on create. Now once you click create a new project, just again select that project from here. As you can see, this is the project. Click on that and select this project. Now that project should show over here. Okay, so now as you can see here, it says business finder. So once you do so, now click on this button at the top which says enable APIs and services. Click on that. Now search for Google Map JavaScript API. Here it is, Google Maps JavaScript API. Select that and click on enable. Enable this API. Okay, once you enable this API, you'll get a new button over here. It says to use this API, you need some credentials. Okay, you need to create credentials. So click on this button which says create credentials. Now from here, select Google Map JavaScript API and click on this button, what credential do I need? Click on this button. Okay, so once you do so, you have the API key over here. Now click on done. So it will show the API key. Now still you cannot use the API key. To use the API key, first we'll have to add a domain name, because our domain name is not registered. So we'll have to register the domain name with Google API. So click on this tab which is domain verification. Now come back to this page, copy your domain name from here, your entire domain name. Come back over here, click on add domain, paste your domain name over here and click on add domain. Now as you can see, first you will have to verify your ownership. So click on take me there. Now again, click on add property, paste in your domain name again and click on continue. Now there is a file, this HTML verification file. Download this file. Okay, here it is. As you can see, the file is downloaded. Now we have to upload this file using FileZilla. Okay, so let me show you how to do that. Open FileZilla first. And here is the file, Google file. Now drag this file again on your website folder. So just drag it. Okay, it says transfer finished. So if you want to confirm whether the transfer is finished or not, you can open this link in a new tab. Okay, if you see something like this over here, which means that this has worked. Okay, so we can cut this thing. Now tick mark over here, I'm not a robot. And click on verify. Okay, as you can see, it says this domain name is now verified. Now we can cut this thing. Again, come back to this page, console.developers.com, and again paste in your domain name over here. Now click on add domain. Now this time it has accepted our domain. As you can see, our domain name is registered over here. Now click on credentials. Here you have the API key. Copy this key from here and come to your dashboard. Click on theme admin from the left hand side. Now here we have different options. So you have to click on this option which says Google. Click on this Google option. And here we have the Google Maps API key. Paste in the API key over here and click on save options. As you can see, this is saving. You will see this tick mark once everything is saved. As you can see, we have this tick mark. Now come back to your website and refresh this page. Okay guys, now as you can see, that error is gone, which means this map is now working. Okay, now first we'll have to set up this map, so which is very easy. The main thing was to register the API key, and after you do that, the error is gone. Now everything is very simple. Now we can cut this page. Now again, come back to this page. Now if you also notice one thing, in the demo website we have the categories and the location section. And here we don't have that. Okay, that is because we haven't created any category or location. So let's create one category and one location, and let's see whether that thing shows up over here or not. So come back to your website, and to create a category, it is very, very simple. Just from the left hand side, you'll see items at the bottom, hover items, and click on item categories. Now as you can see, there is no category at present. Let's add a new one. Let's add a new category called food. So select this and enter food, and you can add some description about the category. Okay, so let's grab some dummy text from here, or let's go to the home page and let's come over here. And here, as you can see, we have some dummy text. Let's copy this dummy text from here and come back over here, paste it over here. Okay, so you can just enter some dummy text or description about this category. Then after that, we have some more option like keyword, icon in map, and all these options. So we have to upload an icon. As you can see here, for every different categories we have an icon. So let's upload an icon. So select icon. Now select files. Now all the files, all the images, everything, whatever I have used in this video, all the images that I have used to create the demo website, I am giving those things for free. Okay, so you'll see a link in the video description below. Click on that link and download all the images for free. Okay, so once you do so, you'll see a folder something like this, media. Okay, in this media folder, everything is given. So what we have to upload at present, we have to upload the icons. So here is the icons folder. Open that. And you have all the icons over here. So you can just select everything and click on open. Now everything is getting uploaded. As you can see, one by one, all the icons are getting uploaded. Now we want only this one, food one. So we can just deselect rest of these things because everything is selected over here. We just want the food one. So select this thing, click on insert into post. Now click on add new category. Now you can see here we have this food category showing up. Let's come back to this page and refresh it. Now as you can see, the category option is showing and we have this food. Okay, which means this is working. Now let's add a location. So to add a location, under items, you will see item locations. Click on that. Again, it says no locations found. So it's really easy to add a location. Let's add a location called Mumbai. Okay, so select Mumbai. And again, you can add some description. So let's see where we have here. We have all the different locations. So let me copy this dummy text from here and let me put it under description. Now we can put some keywords, icons, and all these things. Now for locations, we are not using icons. We are using images. As you can see, we have different images for different locations. So these images are also given. So you can just upload those images. So this time we will not upload an icon. We will upload a location image. So here you have location image. Select this, select image, upload image, select files. Now here you'll see another folder called location. You can select all the images from here, but what I'll do is I'll just select one. Let me select this one, click on open. Okay, here we have the image, click on insert into post, click on add new category. Now the location is also added. Now again, come back to this page, let's refresh it. Now as you can see, now we are seeing the category and we are also seeing the location. So this is working and this map is also working. Now once we do so, let's start creating the most important thing, which is the listing, item listing. Okay, so let me show you how to create a single listing. First, let's see how a single listing looks like on our demo website. So let's open a listing. Okay, so this is how a single listing look like. Okay, we have the map, we have everything. We have the title, all these images and all this different information. So let's start creating this one. Okay, so come back to your website. And at the left hand side, we have this listings. Under listing, you have add new. Click on this add new button. Now we have to add a new item or a new listing. The first option that we get at the top is to enter the title. Now whatever you put the title, it will show up over here. As you can see, let's put the same title so that it will save us some time. I'm putting the same title. After that, we have this box. Here we can add some description or some text. Here is the text. So whatever you type in over here in this thing, it will show up over here, okay, below these images. Then after that, we have some more options, okay, like we have item images. Now these are the item images that are used. As you can see, there are four different images and all the images are having some title. For example, transport directly to us, and we have this image. Romantic scene, we have this image. Okay, all these things have different title and different images. The first one is the same name, which is the name of the restaurant. Okay, this name, this title, and we have this image. So let's see how to upload that. So to set an image, click on this link which says set image. Okay, now let's upload the files. Now again, come to media and you'll see this image over here. This is the image. Select this, click on open. Now click on set featured image, and here we have the image over here. Then we have the subtitle option. Now if you see over here, this is the subtitle, a legendary dining terrace. So whatever you put under subtitle, it will show up over here below this title. Okay, so I'm putting this subtitle over here. Now is whether this item is a featured item. Now because I am the admin, I am the administrator, so I can set this thing whether it is a featured item or not. So I'm putting yes. What do you want to show? Map? Yes, I want to show the map. You have different header options like map or image, but here I want to show the map. So I'm selecting map. Now we have to enter the address over here. So I'll just enter Mumbai and click on find. Now it will find the location. As you can see, now we have the latitude, longitude, everything showing up over here. Okay, after that we have telephone number. So let me put in some dummy telephone number like this one. Okay, here we have this number. Let me copy this. Let me paste it over here. If you have additional telephone numbers, you can add multiple telephone numbers over here. Okay, it's all up to you. Now after that we have this website address and whether you want to show this button, contact owner button or not. Okay, if you make it yes, you can see this button, contact owner. Okay, so this is very important. You should have this. Now we have this email address over here. Now again, let me copy this dummy email address from here and let's paste it over here. Okay, after that we have the website. You can also paste in the website name. So let me again copy this simple website name, paste it over here. Okay, website link label, you can again paste the same thing. Now whether you want to show this tab, the opening hours tab, okay, whether you want to show this section or not, the opening ask section, we obviously want to show this section, so just make it on and put in all the timings. So you can just put in anything, you can type in anything like 7 a.m. to maybe or maybe 4 p.m. Okay, I'm just showing you how to put this. You can put anything, you can put different timing for different dates, but I'm putting the same thing. And for Saturday and Sunday, let's put in holiday, something like that. Okay, so we are working only 5 days a week. You can put some note if you want, whether you want to show the social icons. So yes, we do want to show the social icons. Now let's add some social icons. Click on add a new item. Let's select the icon first. So select this thing, and suppose if you want to add the Facebook icon, just type in Facebook and here you have Facebook. Select this and put the Facebook link. So let me copy my Facebook link, which is facebook.com/blogdude. So I'll copy this thing from here, paste it over here. Okay, copy it from here. Okay, come back over here, paste it. Okay, so we have this Facebook. If you want to add more, click on add new item. Let's add Twitter. Okay, so here we have Twitter. Let me paste the same link. Obviously you can paste different links. Now let's again one more, click on add new. This time let's search for YouTube, my favorite, and paste in the link, whatever link you have. Now whether you want to show the gallery or not, so this is the gallery, whether you want to show this thing or not, we obviously want to show that. Okay, so just click on okay, just make this on, click on add new item, give it a title first. For so as you can see here, we have this thing first. The title is the same as the name of the restaurant, and we have this image. Okay, so let's put this title, select the image, this is the image, select this, click on insert image. Okay, we can add multiple images. As you can see over here, we have another one. Okay, transport directly to us, and we have this image. So let's add this one as well. Click on add new item. Let's type in transport directly to us, and let's add this image. Select image, upload files, select files, and this is the image. Select this one, click on open. Now click on insert image. We have this. Now we can add unlimited number of images over here, but I'll add only two. After that we have features. Now whatever you put under features, it will show up over here. As you can see, the car icon, Wi-Fi icon. When we hover over this, we have different options over here. So let's add some features. We do want to show the features, just make it yes. Let's click on add new item to add a new feature. Select the icon, and you can select anything. For example, if you want to add the Wi-Fi icon, just type a Wi-Fi. We have the Wi-Fi over here. Title, whatever you put under title. As you can see, when I hover this Wi-Fi icon, I get free Wi-Fi. Okay, so whatever you put under title, it will show up over here. So let us put the same title, free Wi-Fi. Okay, if you want to put some more inputs or some more items, click on add new item again. And this time let's search for car. Here it is, car icon, and let's type in parking. So parking facility is also available. Then claim listing, you cannot do anything over here. Then we have item extension, I'll show you that in a moment. First let's see all the basic information. Then after that you have to select the category. Okay, so this comes under food category, and the location, so this comes under Mumbai. Okay, this is under Mumbai. Select this and click on publish. Okay guys, congratulations, because with this we have created our first listing, and as you can see, this was really really simple. Now let's open this post in a new tab. Let's see how the listing is looking. Okay guys, so as you can see, this is how it is looking. We have this map over here, this is the listing. When you click on this, it will show the map or the image, the location, whatever you have put over here, the name, and the show more button. Okay, we also have the map showing, we have all these things showing. We have the title, the subtitle, the images. Okay, we have different images, we have the Wi-Fi, the parking features, we have the text which we put, holiday for Saturday, Sunday. If you remember, we had put this thing. Now our address, telephone number, everything is showing up over here. The map is showing. We have the review section, everything is showing. Okay, now let's see what all things are left. The first thing that we see is left is this section, the features section, or whatever you want to put, because this is the extension section. Okay, and if you see in this page at the bottom, we have this item extension. So we can create different extension according to your business. For example, if you have a business for car listing or car shop listing, you can have, you know, a different extension or different columns for those options. Okay, let me show you how to do that. So if you want to create those things, hover theme admins and click on item extension. Okay, here it is. Now first we have to change this section title. So instead of item extension, let's put in features. Okay, and you can put some description if you want. I'm not putting that. Now admin. Okay, now for this is for admin. Then we have free package and we'll create different packages. Okay, this is the package that user has to purchase to create listing. We'll see these things later on. First, let's create for admin. For example, we can just click on add new item. And what option do you want? Text or email or what? So we want simple text. As you can see, this is simple text, all these things. So first the label, just type in model number. Okay, so I'm just typing in model number. Okay, and just minimize this thing. Again, click on add new item and you can type something like location. It's all up to you. You can type anything. Okay, anything related to your business. Obviously you can add some more options like what else, like for example, if you're operating in India, you must have a GST number that is related to tax. Different countries have VAT, we have GST. So suppose we want user to give their GST number. So I'll just type in GST number over here, which is fine. Okay, these many options are fine. Now we have free package. We have to, we have to add new items, different items for free package and different packages, but we haven't yet created any package. So we'll see how to do these things later on. But once you create a package, again, you have to come back in this item extension and add more. If you want to add some new item extensions, you can add it from here. Okay, we'll see these things later on. First, click on save options. Now again, click on items from the left hand side. And we have one item already created over here. So click on edit. Now again, come at the bottom. Okay. Now we have something over here, features, we have model number, location, GST number. So now we can put some options over here like model number. Let me put Faham 123, location, maybe Pune. Okay, not Pune, just type in Sion, Mumbai, better specific location. Then we have GST number. Let me put my GST number, not the exact one. Something like this. I don't remember my GST number. Let me put some number. Okay, so this is my GST number, whatever it is. Now after you're done with this, just click on update. Now again, come back to this page and let's refresh it. Let's scroll down. Now as you can see, this section is showing you have features, you have model number, location, GST number. Now this is the most important feature, because everyone of you who are watching this video, you might be creating this website, listing website, for different business purposes. Someone might be creating this to list different hotels. Someone might be creating this to list different things, or maybe someone amongst you might be creating this website to list almost anything, but that is not recommended. I would recommend you to stick to a single niche, stick to a single category. That will be more helpful for you, because you're small at present and that is more better for you rather than going, you know, and selecting everything, enabling every options. It's all up to you. You can make your own decisions. It was just a simple suggestion from my side. Okay, so now we have these things as well. Now let's see what is remaining. Now is, if you see, this thing is also remaining. We don't see these things. Claim listing option over here, we don't see this option over here, so we'll have to enable that. And and we also don't have this thing. Okay, how the user will be able to create special offers. So first let's enable this thing, claim listing, and after that let's create special offers. So come back to this page, the dashboard, and click on theme admin. Okay, so first we'll have to enable claim listing so that anyone can claim if someone else has created a listing in their business name, and if I am the owner of the business, I can claim that business. Okay, so that is very useful. So from here you will see an option called claim listing, I guess. Yeah, here it is, claim listing. Click on this option and just make this thing on. Now default package. Now suppose if you want to give this option only for single package, like you have created three different packages, like simple package, which is a free package, then we have medium package and we have professional package. Now suppose you want to give this option only to professional package, then you can select professional package from here. Now we haven't created any package yet, but once you're creating the website, and I'll obviously show you how to create packages later on in this video, if you want to give this option only to premium package or whatever package you want to give, you can select that package from here. Okay, now email subject. What, whenever you select this thing, this is the subject that the user will get. Okay, suppose I am a user, a simple user who has created a website, who has created an account on your website, and I have added a listing on someone else's business, and someone else is now, that person is now claiming that business. So I'll get a mail, that mail will be something like this. The subject of the mail will be this claim listing request, and obviously you can change this thing. Now I'll get the username, item action, everything, claim listing. You can change all these things if you want, but I would not recommend you to do anything over here. Just make this thing on and click on save options. Don't do anything else. Okay, now come back to this page. Let's refresh and see whether we have this option available or not. Now as you can see, we have this option showing. Now it is saying claim listing disabled for current role because I am the administrator, so for me it is disabled. But if you see this website, or if any person is seeing that website, they'll see that option over here to claim their listing. So don't worry, this is working fine. We are just administrator, that's why we are getting this message. Now let's see how to create special offers like this. Okay, a limited time offer. For example, this is lobster dish. Okay, some hotel, it is providing this lobster dish with a very minimum charge of $29.99, and this is a special offer, and this offer is from Jan 16 to maybe Jan 20, few days offer, 1 or 2 days offer, or 5 days offer, 1 week offer. So they can provide special offer to attract customers. So let's see how to create that. So again, come back to your website, and from the left hand side you have special offers, hover that and click on add new. Now let's add a special offer very similar to this one so that we have a better idea how this looks. So here we have, first we have to enter the title. Now here the title is lobster dish. Let's copy this title, paste it over here. Then we have the description over here. Let's copy this description as it is. Come back, paste it over here. Okay. Then after that we have the price. As you can see here, the price is saying $29.99. Now I want to decrease that price. It's all up to me. So I'm putting $9.99, maybe $9.99 US dollars, whatever the currency wants. So I want US dollar. Now available from, I want to put from today till maybe next week. Okay, for 1 week I'm providing this special offer. Now what item, you have to select the item. Now we have created this item recently, so I'm selecting this icon item. Now we have to put the featured image. So this is the featured image that will show. So let me set a featured image, upload files, select files, and this is the lobster image. Select this one, click on open, click on set featured image. Now let's publish this thing. Now once you publish this thing, it should start showing up over here. Let's see, let's refresh this page. Because here, as if you remember, we have selected this item. Okay, that's why. Now if you scroll down, as you can see, this thing is showing over here. We have read more, we have $9.99. as you can see, the date from 20th March, which is today, the day I am recording, 20th March 2018 till 29th March, okay, 2018. So this is working perfectly. Okay, so this is how you create a single listing. Okay guys, so one more thing is left. If you see over here, we don't have the exact same sidebar. If you see the demo website, we have this beautiful sidebar over here. You know, we have this thing, the account login or registration, then we have recent listing, recent comments and our location, but here we have some boring sidebars. So let's change this sidebar. Now this is also very simple. Again, come back to your dashboard, and from the left hand side we have appearances, hover appearances, and click on widgets. Okay, so this is how your widget page should look like. Now here you have different options. Now we have to select the option which says item. Here you have this item section. Now we have to bring all these widgets, whatever we want, under item. Okay, and once we do so, everything will show, start showing up over here. So the first one we want is this login or registration section. So if you see at the bottom, we have this section over here, theme login. So this is the widget. So click on this widget and from here select item and click on add widget. This will show over here. Now you can give a title. For example, here as you can see, the title is submit yours. Okay, so you can just put in the same title over here and click on save. Now you can minimize this thing, and after that, this we have the recent listings. So this is also very simple. You can just select this thing, newest item. Okay, you can also, there is another way of adding, just drag this thing over here and you can put a title like recent listing. Let's put a title of recent listing. Okay, and layout style, you can select any type of layout like list or grid. Now I'm selecting list and excerpt is 100. Click on save. After that we have recent comments. So let's drag that. Okay, let me see, here it is, recent comments. Drag it over here. Okay, number of recent comments to show 5, and we have this title over here, recent comments. So let's add this title, click on save, minimize this, and after that at the bottom we have our locations. So let's drag this as well. So drag this tag columns over here and let's put in the title of our locations. Copy it, paste it over here, and from the taxonomy select item locations, or if you want to show item categories, select item categories and show tag counts. Now it will show the number of items present. Okay, now click on save. Once you're done everything, just click on the, come to this page and refresh it. Okay, as you can see, after we refresh this page, nothing has changed. Although we have added all the widgets in that section, but still we don't see any changes. Now that is because we have not set this section, the item section, as the widget section for this page. Don't worry if you don't understand, it is really simple to fix it. Now at the top, you will see this option which says page builder. Click on that option. Okay, so this is your page builder. Okay, come at the bottom. Here we have this sidebar. Okay, or what you can do first, let's dismiss this. You have this option at the top, layout option, select that option. And here you have the right sidebar, select this, and from here select the item. Okay, because we have put everything under item, so select item from here and click on OK. Now click on save options. Once you do so, again come back to your website. Let's open this website in a new tab. Okay, here is our website. Let's open this listing which we have just created. Let's open it. Okay, now as you can see, everything is showing because we have set this thing as the sidebar. We have this thing over here, the latest item, recent comments, and our locations. So with this, we have successfully completed and created our listing. And this is how an admin or the administrator can create a listing. At the end of the video, obviously, I'll show you how a user or the visitor who is creating an account on your website can create a listing. So stay tuned. Now after that, let's start creating the home page. First, let's see how a home page is looking. So come back to this home page. Again, come back to this home page on this page also. Now this is how our home page is looking, but if you see the demo website, this is how the home page should be looking. So let's start creating this. But before this, first we'll have to create some more things. Like if you see over here, we have this thing, the price tables. We'll have to create these price tables first. Okay, so to do so, it is very simple. Come back to your dashboard and from the left hand side, it is here it is, price tables, hover price tables, and click on add new. Now here you have to enter the title. So whatever you put the title, it will show up over here. For example, here we have basic. Now let's put a basic title. Okay, Now text displayed as title. Here also we have to put the same title, subtitle. Now this is the subtitle, one time yearly fee. So whatever you put in the subtitle, it will show up over here as one time yearly fee or whatever you put. Okay, then we have the description. This is the description. We have some lorem ipsum text, dummy text over here. This is the description. Then the price. Now here the basic thing is showing $200, but I will put zero over here because I want to create three different packages, and the first package should be free package. Okay, so this is the free package. Now we have to put in inputs, whatever option are available in the free package. Now let me give you a very nice idea. What you can do, you can open this thing in a new tab, theme admin, open this link in a new tab. Okay, and from the from this options you have this packages, click on packages, and now just expand this thing, free package. Now if you see over here, there are many different options like content editor, excerpt, image, comment, address, telephone. Now all these are the different options that you want to give to the user and you want to give to a single package. For example, this is the default package, the free package. Okay, so in free package, whatever, what all are the things that you want to provide. So suppose I want the user to have this content editor, they can have the content editor, they can upload the image, which is fine, but they cannot or maybe they can put the address as well, but they cannot put the telephone. Okay, if they want to put the telephone number or the email address or the website, something like this, they will have to purchase a paid subscription. Okay, so we'll not enable all these things, but we'll enable something like this. Opening hours is fine, gallery is fine, features is also fine. Then okay, and this, make sure this thing is tick mark in all the options, in all the package. Admin must approve edited item before showing on front end. So what happens is whenever a person, you know, creates a new listing, it will not be published you know, at that time and in the real time. That listing will come to your side and you will have to manually check that thing. If everything is fine, you can approve that. Or if you want, and if you don't want that step, if you want the user to directly publish the listing, you can just turn this thing off. Now you can make this thing on, content, media, and so on. Header type, whether the user has the ability to select header type, we will select no. Okay, now we have some very special options. Now here we have maximum items. How many maximum items can a user create using the free package? So here it is set to 3. You can increase or decrease this. Now at the top we have two more options which says admin approve. Admin must approve item before showing on front end. And featured, make sure this thing is off. Okay, because we want to give featured items option only to premium packages, because whatever is in the featured item, it will show on the home page. So I don't want anyone to create a free account on my website and their listing should be showing on my home page. But if you want that, you can make this thing on, but I don't want that. Now I'll change this name to basic, which is the name I'm creating over here. Now once you do so, just click on save options first and see everything which is given over here. For example, you have maximum items, so you can click create a new item over here and name it maximum. Okay, here I think I'm getting wrong. Okay, here it is, maximum items 3. Okay, so user will know, it will show up over here. Okay, it will show up over here, so they'll know, okay, with this package you can create maximum 3 items. Then we have content editor, so you can create a new item and type in content editor. Okay, so user will know, okay, you can use content editor. Similarly, we can add address, opening hours and all these things, like add new item, address. Okay, new item, let me put opening. Okay, the spelling is wrong. Opening hours, let's correct this. Okay, so similarly, you get the idea. I hope you get the idea. Similarly, whatever you have make on over here, gallery, features, content, media, you can just put all these options over here. Then we have button text. As you can see, the button over here says get more info. Okay, so if you want the button to say the same thing, you can select it, but I will select something different. I'll just type in select this, or maybe something like this, okay, or maybe click here, something like that. It's all up to you, whatever you want the button to say, okay, just put it over here. Then we have button link. Whenever someone clicks on this button, which is the page that they should be redirected. Now after this, I'm going to create this page, submit listing. After creating the home page, I'll create a new page called submit listing. Now whenever you create that page, just use that page link, okay? So that is what I recommend, okay? So for now, you can just put in your home page link, anything you want. So I'm putting the home page link, but later on in this video, I'll create this page, submit listing page, and this is the page link that you have to put over here. Now, whether you want to make this package as the featured package, no, we want to make this premium package as the featured package. So just make this thing no, and select a category, create a new category from here. And let's select maybe price tables. You can just type in anything you want. Click on add new category, click on publish. Okay, so this is how create a new category. Now let me create a new one more price table very quickly, and let me name it premium. Okay, so the title will also be premium, subtitle will be one time yearly fee, same, which is fine. Description, let me put some lorem ipsum text over here. Okay, lorem ipsum. Price, let's put maybe $50. Okay, now items, again come back over here. Now we haven't created this yet, but here you can create this add new item, and you can name this thing premium. Okay, premium. Okay, and admin approve, which is fine. Now featured item, yes, because this is a paid section or a paid package, the user's listing will be showing on the home page, which is fine. Okay, maximum special offer. Now here, make sure special offer is zero. Yeah, here it is. Special offer is zero, because for the free package, we don't want the user, we don't want to allow the user to add special offer. But with this package, we do want to allow the user to add some special offer. So we can put in maybe 10 special offers. They can put 10 special offers. Maximum items, maybe 100. Expiry limit, you can just put zero for unlimited, or if you want to make it yearly, you can just put 365. Okay, here it says one time yearly fee, which means we have to put 365, and here the price, which is $50. Okay, just put in the 50. Now for, because they are paying, we will on everything. Okay, I don't recommend header type, if you, because if they will give the ability to the user, the freedom to the user to change the header type. Now that is not recommended. Rest everything you can make on, like address, email address, website address, opening hours, social icon, gallery, features, okay, SEO as well. And okay, rest everything is looking fine. Click on save changes. Okay, so similarly, you can just add new item, and because we are providing special offers, so we can type in special offers over here. We are also providing okay, phone number, so you can put in phone number over here. Whatever you're providing in this, you can first put all the options that are available in the free options, and after that put all this option which is available only in the premium option. Okay, and we also have what we have, something special like email address. So you get the idea. This is how you should create. This is the most perfect step of doing what you're doing. Okay, now button text, again I'll just type in click here. Button link, again I'll type in just the website name, but later on you have to change this thing. Now this is the featured thing. Okay, so just select this thing. Now select this category, click on publish. Okay, so this is how you create a pricing tables, different pricing tables. And let's see whether we have to create something else. No, we don't have to create anything. Now let's start creating the home page. Okay, which is very, very easy. Come back to your dashboard, hover pages, click on add new, and let's add a new page called home page. Okay, now click on publish. Now click on this button which says save and open in page builder. Okay, click on this button. Now first let's see how this page is looking at present. So if you see this button over here, view page, click on this button, it will show how the page is looking. Okay, as you can see, this is our page. This is how the home page is looking at present, and we have to make this page something like this. Okay, So let's start doing that. Let's get rid of all these things now. The first thing, if you notice over here, we don't have this thing over here. In this page, we have the page title, we have this breadcrumb, this is called breadcrumb. We have the social settings and we also have the sidebar. First, we'll have to get rid of everything because in the demo website, we don't have all those things, okay? So let's see how to get rid of those things. Click on this option, layout options. And first option is right sidebar. We don't have any right sidebar. We don't want any right sidebar. So select none, okay? Now header type, we want the map, which is fine, but we don't want the breadcrumbs. Okay, so just make this thing off. Footer widget area, which is fine. And rest everything's fine, click on okay. And we also don't want this title, page title and all these things. So here you'll see page title, here it is. Select this and make this off. Share button also, make this thing off. Now click on okay. Click on save options. Come back to this page. Let's refresh and see the changes. Okay guys, as you can see now, those things are gone. Now we can start creating our website. So the first thing that we have is this thing. It is showing all the different categories, okay, that we have on our website, like food, retail, shopping, whatever it is. You can create. Now, if you notice one thing, we have just created one category, okay, that is food, and we have just created one location. So our page will not show something like this because we have only one, but I'll show you how to do that. Okay. So come back over here. The first thing that we have to add is this thing. So to add this thing, we use a module or an element called taxonomy. Now here you'll see at the top, there are many different elements that you can use. The one which we want to use is taxonomy list. Here it is, taxonomy list. So first scroll down. Now select this thing and drag it over here. Okay. Taxonomy list. Now, whether you want to display this, obviously we want to display this. Now, what do you want to display? Image category or locations? So here we have image categories. So we'll select image categories. Now, order by name, order by ascending or descending, and layout. What is the layout? Box or list or icon. You can select anything from anything you want from here. Now, if you see on the demo website, now this thing, this design is called list. So from here, I'll select list. Now number of columns, if you see over here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 columns. So instead of 2, I'm selecting 4 columns. Display description. Now this is the description. So whether you want to display this, yes, we are displaying this on the demo website. So that's why we want to display this. Now carousel, yes, it is carousel, because if you see this arrows, this is what a carousel is. Okay. So we want carousel. Whether you want the carousel to autoplay, no, which is fine. Carousel row 1. Now to go to advanced section and make this thing yes, because here if you notice one thing, the background color of this section is a bit different. Okay, it is not white, it is a bit different. So let's do that. Come back over here and scroll at the bottom. You'll see this background section over here. Select this and you can add any background color. Okay, red, blue, green, whatever you want. But I have a special code, so I'll just type in hash F7 F7 F7. So this is the background color that I want. Now I also want to give some padding at top and bottom, so I'll select 60 pixels top padding top, 60 pixels padding bottom, and 0 pixels bottom margin. Okay, select these things and click on okay. Rest everything is fine. Just click on okay. Click on save options. Come back to your page. Let's refresh it. Okay, let's scroll down. Now as you can see, everything is looking amazing. The background color is different. We have this thing showing up over here. This is the logo. We have the description. Now as I said earlier, because we have created only one, we are not getting this carousel option, but this option is enabled. So just don't worry. Everything is going fine. Okay. Now after that, we have to create this section, which is the best places section. This is actually the featured post or the featured listings. Okay. Now let us see how to create that. Now again, we have created just one listing because I'm creating a demo website, I'm creating a tutorial, I cannot create 100 different listings. So it will show only one listing, but I'll show you the settings, don't worry. So again, come back to your page builder. Now from the top elements, select items, here it is, select items, drag it below taxonomy list, and obviously want to display this. Now, what are the categories that you want? If you want to display only certain category, you can select that category, but I want to display everything. Now, location also, if you want, you can select a certain location or you can select all. Then we have order by, all these things, count, I want to show only 3 or maybe 6, whatever you want, you can select that. Now the layout, what is the style that you want? Now I want box layout this time, and text rows 3, which is fine. Now display only featured items. Just make sure this is on. Okay, we want to display only featured items because featured items are the one which is created by the premium users. Okay, now columns, let's make it 3 because as you can see, we have 1, 2, 3 columns. So let's make it 3. Text alignment, everything should be center aligned. Carousel, we don't have carousel over here. Okay, as you can see, we are not getting those arrows and we don't have this carousel over here. Okay, rest everything is looking fine. Go to advanced, because if you see over here, we have this title, subtitle. So that thing we can put under advanced. Go to advanced, make this thing yes. First thing is title. The title over here is best places. So we can just copy this title, paste it over here. But if you notice one thing, the best is bold and the places is simple text. Okay, this portion is bold and this portion is simple. So if you want to make this thing bold, there is a very simple technique to you to do that. Come back over here and before this text, just type in this arrow bracket and typing strong. Okay, arrow strong under arrow brackets, and again copy this thing and put after best, and now put something like this. Okay, now this is how your title should look. Whatever you want to make bold, for example here the best, we will put that under strong brackets. Okay, here it is, and the places is simple one. After that we have the description. This is the description. Let me copy this. Let's paste it over here. Now alignment, everything is center aligned over here, so which is fine, center aligned. Now background color is white, so we don't have to do any changes. Now we do want to add some padding. Okay, 60% or 60 pixels top and bottom padding, so that we have some gap. If you don't add this padding, if you see this title will stick to this section. As you can see, we have some gap between this section and this title. This is the gap. Okay, as you can see my cursor, this is the gap. So this is the padding. If you want to increase this gap, you can increase the padding. If you want to decrease this gap, you can decrease this padding. Okay, so we have top padding 60, we have bottom padding 60. Click on OK, click on save options, come back to your page. Let's refresh it. Okay guys, so as you can see, we have this thing showing up over here. We have the title, the description, the item showing up over here. We have this icon showing. Now we get this rate now button here. We don't get that because someone has already rated it. Now, because no one has rated it, we get this button, but when someone rates it, we'll get that rating. Okay, so if you see, this thing is also looking amazing. Okay, now if you might have noticed this, guys, this is really, really simple creating a website like this, because this is all possible because of this beautiful theme. This really simplifies our job. You know, this is really, really useful. So I hope you guys are enjoying the tutorial. If you have any doubt, if you're not understanding anything, if you want to request me for new videos on different topics, you can put all those things in the comment section below. If you have any message for me, I would really love to read your comments. Please put them in the comment section below. Okay, now let's see how to create this section. Here we have the same, very similar kind of section like we created over here. Okay, here instead of icons, we have images, and this is locations. Okay, so let's create this section. Come back to this page. Again, drag this taxonomy list element. Here it is. Here it is, taxonomy list, and drag it below items. Okay, yes, we do want to display, but this time we want to display item categories. Now, whether you want to display small or large images, we want small image. So select small. Now layout, box or list or icon, whatever you want. Now here we want the box layout, so I'll select this box. Now columns, let's see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 columns. So instead of 3, let's make it 4. And it is a carousel. As you can see, it is a carousel. We have this thing. Okay, this is what a carousel is. Now go to advanced section, because again, if you see, the background color is a bit different. This is not white. Now this is how a website is created. If you don't know this, that you divide different section accordingly. For example, this is the first section, it has got a map. Then the next section is divided using this background color, different background color. Then after that we have this section, white background color. Then again, when we have next section, we change the background color just to divide that section, and it purifies the website. So this is a very simple technique and a very useful technique. Okay, so we go to this section and let's make it yes. We don't have any title, subtitle, so we can just leave this thing. Now in the background, just type in hash F7 F7 F7. Okay, now again let's add maybe 60 pixels padding top and bottom. Click on okay, save options, come back to your website and let's refresh it. Okay, let's scroll down. Okay guys, so as you can see, we have this location showing, we have the image and everything is showing. I know it is really, really easy and it is really enjoying. Okay, let's see the next section. Here we have these special offers. If you remember, we have created the special offer for lobster dish. So we'll see, we'll show all the special offers that are going at present over here. Okay, so let's see how to do that again. Now you won't find this special offer over here in the columnable elements. You will find that under full with elements. So click on full with elements and let's see, here we have special offers. Drag this thing under taxonomy list. Yeah, we do want to display this, and if you want to display only certain category special offer, you can select that category, certain location, select that location. Okay, everything is fine. Just yeah, you don't have to do any changes actually. Okay, everything is really easy. We do have to add this title and this description. So for that, we'll have to make this advanced section yes. Okay, what is the title? This is the title. Okay, special offer this week. And again, we have to put this thing under strong because this thing is bold. Special offer is bold. So let me put this thing under strong. Now it is fine. After that, we have this simple description. Let me copy this, paste it over here, and everything is center aligned, which is fine. We don't have to change the background color. Now let's add some padding, maybe 60 pixels top and bottom. Click on OK. Click on save options, come back to this website, let's refresh it. Now let's scroll down. As you can see, we have this option over here. We have the special offer showing, we have the title, subtitle, everything is looking amazing. Now after this, we have the recent listing showing up over here. So let's add this thing again, come back over here, again go to the columnable elements, select this item, drag it under special offer. Okay, now what all are the categories that you want to display? All, location, all, everything is fine. Now we don't want to display 99, we just want to display maybe 6. We have only one, but we can display 6. Layout is list, text row 3, which is fine. Only featured items, yes. Carousel, this is not a carousel, so let's make it no. Now go to advanced, because we have to put this, you know, we have this title and description, that's why we have to go to advanced. Go to advanced and make it yes. Put this title recent places and put this description. Now this time this is not center aligned, this is left aligned. So we'll select left align from here, and again padding top and bottom, let's select 60 pixels. Click on OK. Let's click on save options, come back to your website, let's refresh it, let's scroll down. Now as you can see, this is also showing and this is looking really, really beautiful. Okay, we have the recent places showing up over here. We have only one, that's why it is showing only one. We have, after this, we have this section. This is also a very easy section. It might look a bit complicated, but this is a very easy section. Let us see how to do that. Come back over here, and if you see over here, we have three different columns. Okay, we have this column and this column. So for this, we have to, you know, get the columns thing. So which is under full width element. Go to full width element, and here we have the columns element. Select this, drag it over here. Now first we have to divide this thing into three different columns. As you can see, we have 1, 2, 3 different columns. So select this and select this one, 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3. Select this, and we have three different columns now. Now this is simple text. As you can see, this is just simple text. So let's again come to columnable elements and search for text. Here it is. Drag this text under the first column. Now let's put in some text over here. So here it says, first one is this, number one, hundreds of places, and after that we have some simple, you know, text. So just copy and paste it over here. Okay, let me see. Okay, fine, this is looking better. But if you see one thing, the this color is white and this is a bit something like gray color. So let's do that. Select this thing and select this text color, make it white. Now select this thing. Again, select the text color, and above that white, you have this light gray color, medium gray. Select that one. Okay. Now click on OK. Now similarly, you can drag this thing over here in the second one. Let's do that. Text, drag it over here. Let's copy this text. It's actually the same text. I forgot to change this, but you can change this text from here. Okay. Again, let's make it white. Text color white. Let's select this section. Let's make it medium gray. Okay. Similarly for the third one, just select it, drag it over here and paste it. Make it white. Select this one like this. Make it gray. Click on okay. Fine. So we have these three things showing, but we also have a title and we also have a background image. So let's see how to do that. So to do so, go to advanced section, make it yes. And our title is everything you need in one place. So let's copy it, paste it over here. It is center aligned, obviously. But here the background, we don't have a color. We have a image in the background. So let's select this image. Click on select image, upload files, select files, and let's search for that file, which should be under, I guess. Okay, here it is. This is the file. Select this, click on open, click on insert image, which is fine. Now the title color here is white. Okay, here or every time the title color was something like this, but here the title color is white. So we'll have to select title color white from here. Okay, if you don't see this, just put hashtag FFF, 3 times F or 6 times F, it will give you white color. Now let's add some padding, maybe 60. Not this time, we don't want 60. We want some more padding at the top. So let me put maybe 100 at the top and bottom 60 is fine. Let's click on save option. Let's see how it looks. Come back to this page. Let's refresh it. Okay, as you can see guys, so this is looking really amazing. Okay, exactly like this section. Okay, so we are done with this as well. Now in the demo website, I by mistakenly did this thing 2 times, but we'll improve this thing over here. Okay, so first what we have different price table and we have this simple title and subtitle. Okay, so let's do that really easy. Come back over here and search for price table. Let's see. I think we don't have it over here. So we will have it under full width element. Select full width element. And here we have the last one, price table. Drag it over here. Okay. Display. Yes, we want to display horizontal or vertical. Horizontal. Category. We have this price table category. Select that. And yeah, we have the title subtitle. So go to advanced. Make this thing yes. Copy this title. Paste it over here because packages is strong. You can put this under strong. Now after that, we have this description. Copy it. Description. Everything is center aligned, which is fine. And let's add some gap at top and bottom, maybe 60 pixels top and bottom. Select this, click on OK. Click on save options. Come back to this page. Let's refresh it. Okay, as you can see, this is how it is looking. Now this is not looking good. The reason is very simple, because here we have 3 and here we have only 2. Now I have just shown you how to do that. You can create 3, 4, 5, any number of price table you want. But as you can see here, we are seeing this, we have set this thing as the premium one. That's why we are seeing the color difference. And here this is the basic feature. Okay, but this is how you create it. You get the idea. After that, we have this section. We have the title, we have some text, and here we have a button. Okay, it says register now for free, and this button will also redirect to submit listing. Now because we have not created that page yet, so we'll just leave the link, but later on, once you create this page, you should link this page, link this button to that page. Okay, so we'll see how to do that. Come back over here, come back to this page, and here this is just simple text. Okay, so let me show you how to do that. Now go to columnable elements and drag this text. Okay, drag it at the bottom. And let's see what all we have. Okay, just copy this thing first. Okay, copy it. make everything center align. Select everything, select center align. Now after that, press enter and click on center align button. Now we need to add a button. So the best way to add a button is by using short codes. So if you see over here, when you hover this button, it says insert short codes. Now click on this. The first option is a button. Select that. Now the title. What is the title? So as you can see here, the title is register now for free. So let's put in that title. Register now for free. Okay, title color. Here the title color is white. So let's select white from here. Description, we don't have any description. Description color not required. Text alignment center. Width, in the width just type in 240 pixels. URL, you can put in the URL of this page that we'll be creating later on, submit listing, but for now just leave this thing as it is. Now button color. Now if you want to know the color of this button, now let me show you a very simple trick that will be very, very useful to you throughout your lifetime. Whenever you want to use, or whenever you want to know the button color or any text color or anything on a website, there is a very simple trick. Just right click on this button, click on inspect. Now once you do so, you'll get this thing over here. Now at the right hand side, you have this small column. Just scroll down that column till you see some color. Okay. Now as you can see here, we have this color. Okay, as you can see, we have this color thing over here. Copy this code, cut this thing, come back over here, and in the button color, paste it over here. Now as you can see, we have this button. Now button alignment is right. We don't have any icon, so we can just leave this thing. Okay, rest everything is fine. Just click on insert short code. Everything should be fine. Okay, once you're done, go to advanced, because we have a image in the background. I don't know if you can notice that, but we have a image in the background of this section. Also, we have a nice amount of gap at top and bottom. So let's add that. Let's make it yes first, and we don't have any title or anything. So just go at the bottom in the background section, select image, upload files, select files. And where is that image, by the way? Let's go to media. Here it is. Select this image, click on open. Now click on insert image, and let's add maybe nice amount of padding, maybe 100 at top and 100 at bottom. Click on OK. Now click on save options. Come back to this page, refresh it. Let's scroll down, and as you can see, this is looking exactly like this one. After that, we have the last section for the home page, because below that we have the footer, which we'll see at the end. Okay, now this is the last section of this home page. Now as you can see, within few minutes we have created the home page. Okay, we will be creating the home page, which is almost finished. Okay, so this is how easy it is to create a website. Now to use this thing, first we'll have to create something called partners. So it is also very easy. Scroll up at the top, and at the left hand side you'll see these things. Okay, partners. Hover partners and click on add new. Now don't click on add new, just right click on add new and click on open link in a new tab, so that we stay on this page and we create a new partner. Now partner is nothing, it's a very simple thing. Let me show you. Just add a new title. So I'm just typing in partner one, because we just have to put in the logo, nothing else. Now set a partner logo, click on upload image, select image. And you will see all these things under, I guess, under icons, under logos. Okay, select this logo. Now select the first one, click on open, click on set featured image. And you can give it a category. So let's give it a category. Let's type in partners, click on add new category. Okay, you can link this thing to some page or something you want. I don't want to link this to anything. So I'll just leave this thing blank and click on publish. Okay. Now similarly, you can add all the partners. It is really easy. You know how to do that. Click on add new, add a title, and add an image. You have the image in the background, in the description, in the video description below, there is a link. Click on that link. You will be redirected to my website. On there, you'll find all the images. Okay. So download that and you can use all these images. Now let me cut this thing. Come back over here. Let's refresh this page. Okay, now let's scroll down and let's search for partners. Okay, here it is. Okay, here it is. Partners, let's drag it at the bottom. Okay, display, yes, category all, or if you want to display only the partner category, you can select this, order by that. Now custom spaces. Now custom spaces, just type in 25. Now go to advanced section, because if you see the color of this section is something like dark blue, something like that. Let's search, let's inspect element, right click over here, select inspect. And here it is, the background color, copy this color and come over here. And the advanced section, make this thing yes. Go to background section, click make, paste this color. Now come at the bottom, and in the bottom margin, just type in 0. Click on OK. Click on save options. Come back to this page. Let's refresh it. Okay guys, so as you can see, we also have this partner section. Now because we have only one logo, it is showing something like this. When you create different partners, it will show something like this. Okay, but you know how to do that. Okay guys, so with this, so easily, so simple, we have created our home page. Now after that, we'll see how to create this page, this submit listing page. Okay, let's see how to do that. Okay guys, so let's start creating this submit listing page. So to do so, come back to your dashboard, and from the left hand side, hover pages and click on add new. Now let's enter the title of submit page, anything you want, it's all up to you. Click on publish. Click on this button which says save and open in page builder. Now if you see over here, the submit page is a bit different. Okay, we don't have that map at the top, but we do have something like this. Okay, we have the title, we have some subtitle. So we'll have to do some changes at the beginning. First, let's get rid of this home page and let's open this page or view this page in a new tab. So this is how our submit page is looking at present. Okay, so we first will have to get rid of this map, and we will have to add something like this. Okay, small search bar over here. So let's do that first. Click on this layout option and header type, just select none. Okay, we don't want any header, and we do want the breadcrumbs over here, and right sidebar, we don't want any sidebar. Yeah, we don't want any sidebar. So in this right sidebar, select none, click on OK. Now select this thing, search form, and instead of this side search form, select search form, the first option. Okay, type should be search form, select this, click on OK. And select the page title. If you see over here in the demo website, we have the page title and we also have this subtitle. So here we don't have that subtitle, but let me show you how you can put that. Just type anything over here in the description, it will show in the subtitle. Click on OK. Let's click on save option. First, let's see these basic changes. Click on this refresh button. Now as you can see, the map is gone, we have this beautiful thing, and everything is looking exactly like the demo website. Now let's see how to create this thing. Okay, here we have this first widget, then we have this simple text, and we have recent listing showing up over here. Now to use this widget, first we'll have to add this widget. Now this is the same widget which we have added earlier in the listing page. If you remember, when we are creating the single listing, this was the first widget that we added. Okay, so this is very easy. So let me show you how to do that. First, we'll have to add this listing. So to do so, hover appearances and open this widgets link in a new tab. Now here you'll see this registration thing over here. Now what we'll do, we'll select the theme login and select registration, click on add widget. You can give it any title you want. Okay, for example, let's see whether we have any title over here. We don't have any title, so we don't need to put any title over here. Just click on this save button and minimize this thing. Now again, come back to this page, and first thing is that we have to divide this section into three different columns. So let's do that. Go to full width elements, drag this column over here. Let's divide this thing into three columns. Select this one. Okay, the third option. And after that, in the first, we have this widget in the first column. So select this option. Okay, where it is, widget option. The last option, here it is, last element, widget area. Drag this thing under column 1, and in the widget area, select the registration. Okay, and click on OK. Let's click on save options and come back to this page. Let's refresh and see whether that is working or not. Okay guys, so as you can see, this is successfully working. We are getting the same thing over here. Okay, now after that we have this simple text and this simple thing over here. Now all this is just simple text. Let's see how to do that. Really simple. Again, come back over here. Let's get rid of this. Drag this simple text over here in the second column. And you can just copy this thing from here. We don't even have to type it. Okay, and paste it over here. Click on OK. Click on save options. Come back over here. Let's refresh and see the changes. Okay, now as you can see, it is showing exactly like that. And in the third column, we have the recent listings, featured listing, whatever you want to put. If you want to put only a certain category, you can put it over here. So let's add that. So let's search for items. Here it is, items. Let's drag it this under the third column. Now all category, yes. I want to show only featured items. Now number of counts we want to show, maybe 10. It's all up to you. And 13, okay, fine. 13 is also fine. Now we have to decrease the rows, or maybe the columns, not the rows. So let me search for that option. Count is 3, type is list, which is fine. Text row 3, which is also fine. Carousel, which is very important. Now carousel rows, just make it 1, or maybe 3 is fine. And we want one more option. Let me search for that. Okay, wait. Okay, it is autoplay, which is fine. It is autoplay. Now I had one more option. I'm not getting that. Okay, first we'll have to select the box layout. Instead of this list layout, we want the box layout. And I have to change something. Let me search. Do we have that over here? Oh yeah, here it is. Column, instead of 4, I just want 1 column. Now we want the center align, which is fine. Now image format, instead of this 1x1, select this one, 16x9. Okay, so make sure you have all these changes, all these settings. Now click on OK. Everything should be fine. Click on save options. Come back to this page. Let's refresh it. Okay guys, so as you can see, this is showing exactly like this one. Now because we have only one, it will show just one every time. Once we have more, it will show everything. Okay, now after that we have this section, frequently asked question section, and we have two different frequently asked questions. Okay, so to add this, first we'll have to create one FAQ, or frequently asked question. So it is really easy to create one. Just hover FAQ from the left hand side and add or open this link, the add new link in a new tab. Now we have to enter the question over here. So the question is, this is what the question is. It is some simple lorem ipsum. Let's copy it, paste it over here. Okay, this is the title actually. The question is over here and the answer is over here. So this is the answer. Copy it, come back over here, paste it over here. You can add a category. Let's add a category. Let's call it FAQ, F-A-Q, capital. Add a new category. Okay, just click on publish. It is that simple, guys. Okay, now come back over here. Let's drag the FAQ. Here it is. Let's drag this thing at the bottom over here. Okay, number of FAQs to show. If you want 3, if you want 2, whatever you want, you can select this. Now we have some title and subtitle, so we'll have to make this advanced section. Yes, and we also have a different background color, so we'll see how to do that. First, let's put this title, frequently asked questions, and this description, some dummy text, put it over here. It is all left aligned, so select left align from here. Now come back over here, we have to put in the background color. Let's see what is the background color. Let's right click over here, select inspect. Okay, here it is, the background color. Just copy this color from here, come back to your website, paste the color code. Now as you can see, the background color is showing. Now come back over here, we have some more thing. Yeah, rest everything is looking fine. Hopefully we have this padding. Let's add 60 pixels padding top and 60 pixels padding bottom. Click on OK. Save options. Hopefully it should work fine. Let's refresh this page. Let's scroll down. Okay, this is looking amazing, as you can see. Okay, the color I think was a bit darker. You can select a lighter shade of that color. Okay, let me show you how you will select a lighter shade. It is really simple. Again, select this FAC, go to advanced, background color, and here as you can see it says 100%, so you can make it maybe 40%. As you can see now it is lighter color. Click on OK, save options. Again, come back to this page. Let's refresh it. Okay, now we have a very light color and this is looking much better. Now after this we have the last section for this page, very simple section. Okay, we have this thing over here. Okay, then let's see how to add this thing. Very simple. So come back over here and let's search for this one, item info, and drag this thing below FAC. Okay, now display item info, but we don't want to display separator, just make it off. And now go to advanced. Now if you see over here, the background color is something different. Let's inspect this. Let's inspect element. Here it is, the background color. Select this thing, make this thing yes. Okay, go to background color. Let's put this color and let's make it maybe 60. And you have to come back again over here and select the light objects and select the white color, or just type in hash FFF. Okay, select this thing, click on OK. And I just noticed one thing, that in the FAC section we didn't put the bottom margin 0. If you don't put the bottom margin 0, you'll see some gap over here, white gap, that will not look good. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll go to FAC, I'll scroll down, and in the bottom margin I'll put in 0. Click on OK, click on save options, come back to this page. Let's refresh it. Okay, as you can see now this is looking exactly like this one. Okay, so with this we are done with this page also, submit page. Now what you can do, you can go to home page and all the everywhere where I said you that you have to put in this code, you just copy this link and put all those change all those links. For example, in the table which we created, we had the link, so put this link in that table. Okay, so whenever someone clicks on that page in the table section on that button, they should be redirected to this page. Fine. Now let's start creating the contact page. So first let's see how the contact page looks. Let's click on contact from the demo website. So this is how our contact page looks, very simple. Okay, so again come back over here. Now first, before creating a contact page, we'll have to create a person or a member. It is called member because if you see over here, there is some image displayed, some name, some phone number and everything. Now this thing will be displayed when we create a member. So let's create a member first, hover members and click on add new. Now first is the name. Now this is the name, Mr. Martin Perks. Copy this, paste it over here. Position. Okay, here, what is this? Support. This is the position. What kind of position is this? Just copy and paste it over here. About member. When you hover this, as you can see, we get this text. Now this is what about member is. Copy this, paste it over here. Sort description, paste the same thing. Contact data. This is the contact data. Okay, phone number, hotline. So let's add a new item. Title. This is the title, phone. I guess this is the title. Okay, the everything. Okay, fine. Just select everything. Okay, fine. Don't put anything over here in the link. Now the next one is hotline. Just copy this. Add new item, paste it over here, which is fine. Now social icons, we have Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, whatever you want. Click on add new. Title, just type in Facebook, select the icon and type in Facebook, select this one. You can put any link you want. Let's create a new one. Let's type in YouTube, select the YouTube icon, search for YouTube, here it is. And you can put any link you want. Now members photo, click on set members photo, click on upload files, select files, and let's search for this person in the contact folder. Here it is, select this photo, click on open, click on set featured image, and after that we have this category. Just add a new category and type in member, click on add new category, click on publish, and this should be done. Okay, we have the map which we'll see how to put. Okay, rest everything is looking fine, we have everything. So once you are done, just cancel this thing. Now come back to the dashboard. If you don't know how to do that, hover here and this is your dashboard. Open this link in a new tab, or what you can do, you can just put in your website name /wp-admin. It will get you to this page, your dashboard. Now go to pages, click on pages. Now click on add a new page and let's create contact us page. Okay, click on publish. Now click on save and open in page builder. Now let's start creating the page and let's start building it like this. So first let's cut this thing. Okay, so this is the page builder. Now first let's open this view page in a new tab. So this is how it is looking. Again, we'll have to get rid of everything over here, all this map and all these things. So let's do that. Click on layout option. We don't want the sidebar, so let's select no. We don't want the breadcrumbs, we don't want the header, so let's select none over here. Click on OK. We also don't want the page title, so select page title, make this off. Click on OK. And search form, we don't want to use this as well, so select this, make it off, click on OK. Okay, rest everything's looking fine. Let's click on save options. Come back to this page, let's refresh it. Okay, so we don't have anything showing up over here, which is fine because we don't have anything over here. Now let's start creating this beautiful page, the contact us page. This is the first section. As you can see, there is a beautiful background image and we have some text over here. Let's add that. So first we'll have to add the columns. Let me copy this. Let me drag these columns, because if you see over here, this is a small column and rest everything is nothing. Okay, we just have a background image. Let me show you how to do that. So the first column that we want is 1x3 and 2x3. Let me search over here. We have 2x3, 1x3. Select this and drag the 1x3 at the left hand side, because we have the smaller one over here and the bigger one over here. Now let's select the main background. Okay, the main column. So go to advanced section. This is the main column. Make it yes. As you can see, there is a background image. Okay, so what I'll do, and also background color. So I'll just add some simple background color, F6. We also have this background color. So select image, upload files, select files. And this is the background image under the contact folder. Select this, click on open, insert image. Now if you see over here, there is a nice amount of gap at the top. Okay, at the top of this section. Okay, so let's add that. So let me add maybe 150 padding top. Now padding bottom should be 0 and margin bottom should also be 0. Okay, now once you do so, again come back to the basic section. Now in this we have to add this text. Okay, so let's drag this text in the first column, 1x3. Let's add this text, very simple text. Select this, paste it over here, select everything, and yeah, it is center aligned. Make it center aligned and select the text color, make it white. Okay, because it is white. Now go to advanced, make it yes. Okay, we don't have any title, anything. We have the background color. The background color is different. Let's inspect this. Here it is, background color. Copy this, paste it over here. Now let's put top padding 30, bottom padding maybe 20, and bottom margin should be 0. Select this, click on open, click on save options, come back to this page, let's refresh it. Okay, as you can see now, when we refresh this page, we see some gap at the bottom. I don't know why is that, but we'll see how to fix that later on. Don't worry, first come back over here. Now let's add some new columns. Let's stay over here. Select full width element, drag this column below this one. Now let's change the columns. As you can see over here, just exactly like the top one, 1x3 and 2x3. Let's make it 2x3, 1x3. Let's drag this 1x3 at the left hand side. And here we want the member. So drag the member. This is okay. Here is where it is. We don't have it, so here it is, member. Drag this thing over here. Now select the member, this is the one. Image format 1x1. Okay, display contact data, which is I think we don't have to drag the member, we have to drag the members one, okay, the plural one. Here it is, members one. Drag this thing over here, category, the whatever category you want, count, I just want to show one, okay, select one over here, box, which is fine, show contact data, so show social icons, columns, just select one. Now go to advanced. If you see over here, we have some changes over here. The title over here is white color, okay, so we'll have to do some changes over here. Make this thing enable, yes, and here we have the title color, just make it white, okay. And also if you see over here, the position color is black. As you can see, the support here, it is black. So let's search for position color. Here it is, let's make it black. So I think it is 000. Yeah, it is 000. And padding bottom, let's make it 0. Okay, make padding bottom is 0 and click on OK. Now after that, we have this simple map. So let's get the map section, let's get the map element, let's search for it. I think it is in under full width element. Okay, let me search for that. Here it is, Google map. Drag this thing below this members. Now make this display on normal map, yes. Content size, let's increase this to 400. Now click on add new item because we want to show the map location. As you can see here, we have this map location. So we want to show this map over here, fine. So we'll have to add some title and something. Okay, for example, when someone clicks on that, they should see the title. So let's put a title, like you can put the title as your business name. So I'm just typing business finder. You can put some description if you want. I'm putting the same description. And here you have to add the address. So I'm just typing Mumbai. Okay, now it should take, here also you have to put the address. Just type in Mumbai, click on find. Now this is the map that it will show, okay. Now go to advanced, make this thing yes, because we have to change some settings over here. Go at the bottom, in the top margin type in minus 38, and in the bottom top padding 0, bottom padding 0, and bottom margin also 0. Click on OK, save options. Let's come back to this page, let's refresh it. Okay, this is looking amazing, but I don't know what is this, why is this thing showing up over here. Let me refresh this again. I think I have added some element at the top by mistakenly. Let me show. Okay, here it is. So we have to delete that. I think I added this by mistakenly. Again, click on save options, come back to this page, let's refresh it. Okay, now it is looking exactly like the demo website. Okay, so we wait a minute, we don't have we have the map over here. Okay, when you click on this, you have the business name and all these things over here. Now after that, at the right hand side, we have to add this map, very simple. We have to add this contact form, and below that we have this fact. So let's do that, come back over here. Okay, so let's search for contact form. Here it is, drag this thing over here under 2x3. Fine. So now here, let's start doing all this thing, all these options. Email address of recipient, put in your email address over here on which you want to accept all the emails. Okay, whenever someone fills this form, what is the email that they want to get? Okay, now in the subject, you can type in the subject, like you can type in inquiry, business inquiry, something like that. Okay, inquiry, you can type something like that. Sender email address, now it is recommended to type something related to your website, like info at business finder website or whatever your website name is. Here it is, bf1.nayashek.com. so info at bf1.nayashek.com, so that you know, okay, this is the place the messages are coming from. Okay, now here it is, the email content, how should the email that you get should look like. So it's all up to you. For example, you can just type in as the title as business inquiry from whatever your website name is, from maybe businessfinder.com. It's all up to you. Okay, and after that, whatever do you want to put, for example, name, and after that we have to put in this code, okay, this simple code over here. Just put a name and put this code. Now after that, whatever you're putting, for example, here we have mail, email address. So after that, let's put in email, and after that you have to put in the code for email. So just copy this same thing again, and instead of name, just type in email. Okay, and after that, what we have the message. So again, message. Okay, paste this thing instead of name, just type in message. Let's, okay, fine. So this is how the format will be that you will be getting. Now success message, you can change this. The form was successfully sent and everything. Now I don't want to use captcha, so I'll just make this thing off. Now inputs, because here we have added three inputs, name, email, message. Here also we'll have to add three inputs. So click on add new. Label, we don't want to put any label at present. Now input, just make sure you type in name in small letters. Okay, whatever you have put over here under this brackets, this curly brackets, this is what you have to put. Okay, here we have put name. So here also just put simple name. Now input type, just select text value. Okay, whatever the value is, or the placeholder. The placeholder here is name. As you can see inside that box, it is saying name. So you can just type in something like enter your name, something like that. Okay, size, we are selecting half size. Okay, as you can see, this is half size, this is half, and this is half. So let's now minimize this, click on add new item, leave this label, and in the name here we have put in email. So under the curly brackets, just copy this email and put it under name, and input type, select email. Placeholder, you can just type in like enter your email. Again, half size, whether it is required or not, yes, it is required. And last thing is add new element, and name should be message. And here also we'll select text area. Placeholder, enter your message. Fine. Full size, which is fine. Required, if you want to make it required, just select yes. And rest, everything is looking fine. Click on OK, or maybe let's see whether we have any. And now go to advanced, make it yes. And this time custom width, put in 600. Now because if you see over here, this is not full width. Okay, if this was full width, it would look really bad. Okay, it will stretch like this. It is all under a very small space. Okay, as you can see, this is the only space it is taking. So we want to put custom width of 600. Okay, this is very, very important. Now come back and let's put now scroll down and put bottom padding as 80, because as you can see below this map, there is nice amount of gap. So put bottom padding 80, click on OK. Now this was the map, this was the form, I'm sorry. Now above this form, we have this simple title and subtitle. So let's add that. Let's get this text and let's put above this form. Let's copy this title subtitle from here. And let's go to visual, paste it over here. Now again, go to advanced, and for this also, custom width should be 600. And let's add some padding. Top padding maybe 100, bottom padding just small 10, because as you can see over here, above this title there is a nice amount of gap, and below there is a very simple gap, because below this we have this form. So do that. And after that we have this fact section, let's add that. So come back over here and let's search, here it is. Drag this thing over here below this form. We want to show only two, so select two, go to advanced, make this thing yes. Again, select custom with 600, rest everything is fine, click on OK. Click on save options, come back to this page, let's refresh it. Okay, so this is looking good, except for this thing, we have some error, enter some content in the text area. Let's see what is the error, select this thing, come back, okay, we didn't put anything over here, which is fine. Let's copy it from here, copy it, paste it over here, Okay, save options, come back again. Let's refresh it. Okay, so this is looking nice. With this, we have completed the contact us page. Now let's see a few more things. Like we have the footer left, we have the navigation bar left, and the most important thing, which is the payment setting, that is also left. So let's do that first. Let's see the footer. So again, come back over here and where is it? Here it is, hover appearances, and click on widgets. Now here we have footer widget 1, widget 2, widget 3. So under footer widget area 1, we want a simple image. So let me select that. So there is no widget image. So what you can do, you can select this text one and drag it under footer widget area 1. Now you can click on this add media, upload files, select files, and let me select that. Okay, you can select any file you want, like your company image. So this is the image which I have. I'll select this thing. This is the image I have used over here. This is just a simple image. Okay, select this, click on insert into post, and we have this thing over here. Now click on save. Now again, just minimize this. The second one is the latest items. So we have this thing over here, newest items. Select this and select the footer widget area 2. Click on add widget. Here we have, let's type in recent items maybe. Click on save. Okay, after that, in the third, we have this simple login register. So select this theme login, footer widget area 3, add widget. Let's add a title of register slash login. Okay, click on save. And the last one, we have some simple text, and after that we have a button. So this is also text. Here it is, select this text, footer widget area 4, select this first. Let's give it a title of get in touch. Okay, this is the title. Now you can use this thing, or there are many different ways of doing it actually. Now it will be difficult for you to do all this thing because this is just some simple coding. So what you can do is, there is a very simple method, hover post, click on add new. Okay, now here you can add those things, and you can, you know, copy and paste this. Let me show you what I mean. Just copy this text first. Okay, paste it over here, and after that we have this button. Okay, so again, I have shown you how to do this. To add a button, click on add new shortcode. Now what does this button say? It says contact us. So instead of this title, just type in contact us. Title color is white. Okay, let's put white. We don't have any description. Alignment is left. Okay, you can change the size. Maybe instead of 200, let's make it 240, or maybe just make it 200. That will be better. Now we have recently created the contact page, which is this. So copy this contact page link, because this is the button for contact us. Paste it over here. Now button color, let's search for this color. Let's inspect and let's search for the color which we see. Let us see. Here it is. Copy this color from here. Come back, paste in the button color. Button alignment is also left. Okay, rest everything looks fine. Click on insert shortcode. Now once you're done with everything, just select everything, click on a copy and paste everything over here. Now click on save. Come back to this website. Let's refresh it. Now as you can see, everything is showing. We have this thing over here, we have recent items, we have this thing showing, and we also have this. The button sizes, I think, are quite bigger. You can decrease the button size. Rest everything is looking amazing, exactly like this one. Okay, now we also have this bottom footer. If you could see this, we have this bottom footer, this copyright text. Let's see how to change that. Let's cut this thing, leave it. Come back over here, click on theme admin. Now here we have the footer, click on footer. You can change the footer background color and all these color settings. It's all up to you. And here we have the text, 2016 copyright by whatever it is showing. Let's first remove the text. Let's put 2018 copyright by, let me put my name, Nayar Sheikh. Okay, all right, reserved. Let's remove this lorem ipsum. Okay, So it's all up to you. Click on save options. Again, come back to this website. Let's refresh it. Now, as you can see here, it says 2018 copyright by Nayar Sheikh. So this is also done. Now at the same time, let's see how to put this thing. Okay, maybe let's first create a menu. As you can see, this is not the menu we want. We want a different kind of menu. Okay, like this. First, let's see how to change the logo. Here it is, the logo. Select the header. And I don't think, okay, here it is, website logo. If you want to change the logo, select this image, put any logo you want and click on insert image. Now I don't want to change this logo. I'm fine with this one, but I'm showing you so that you can change the logo, because obviously you might want to change this logo because you cannot keep this dummy logo. Fine. So once you're done, let's start creating the menu. So again, come back over here, hover appearances and click on menus. Let's create a new menu. You can name it anything. I mainly name it main menu. Click on create menu. Now make sure main menu and footer menu is selected. Now when you select main menu, this menu will show up over here. And when you select footer menu, this menu will show up over here. So I want the menu to show both at the bottom and over here. So the first thing that we have is the home page, contact and submit page. We want only these three pages, okay? And instead of home page, it should say only home. So I'll select home and delete page from here. Fine. Click on save menu. We should have only three options over here. Let's refresh it. As you can see, we have only three options. So this is also working. Now let's see how to put this text over here. Like we have this thing, phone number and everything. But here it says my WordPress blog. It is very easy. Again, come back over here and let's search for settings. Here it is, settings. Now instead of this tagline, put in this text, copy this text and paste it over here and change your number and your email address. Click on save changes. Again, come back over here and let's refresh it. Now as you can see, we have all this text over here. Now there's one more thing left. If you click on this icon and if you see, we have created the home page, but that home page is not showing up over here. Now that is because we have to set that home page as the home page. Let me show you what I mean by that. Come back to this setting page and under this setting, we have this reading option. Click on reading and instead of our latest or your latest post, select this one, a static page, and the home page, select the home page that we have created. Click on save changes. Now again, click on this icon. Let's see what happens. Now, as you can see, the home page that we have created is showing over here. Okay, so we have done this thing. Now one more thing, in fact the most important thing is left, that is the payment option. Let's see how to set up that. So again, come back to this page and click on theme admin. Now if you want to enable PayPal, you can use PayPal. If you want to enable Stripe, you can use both Stripe. Now I recommend Stripe over PayPal because in Stripe you can accept payment on your homepage. On your own website, you don't have to go to some other website, whereas in PayPal you have to go to PayPal's website to make the payment. The user or the customer has to go to PayPal to make the payment. Now PayPal is mainly used throughout the world. I think every country supports that. I don't know, I'm not sure, but Stripe, where there are many few countries that support it at present. In fact, India is also not supported in Stripe is also not supported in India as well. So obviously it will be coming very soon in India, but I'll show you how to use both the payment gateways, how to use both PayPal and Stripe. And after that, we'll see a demo how a user can come to your website and sign up, and we'll just finish up this tutorial. Okay. So come to this page and click on payments. Now we don't want bank transfer, so we'll make this thing off. We do want PayPal and we also want Stripe. So make this thing on and click on save options. Okay, once you click on save options, you'll have PayPal and Stripe over here. First go to PayPal. Now there is only one single thing that you have to do. Very simple. You have to put in your username, your password and your signature. Now where will you get this? Open a new tab, go to paypal.com. Okay guys, once you come to your website, to your PayPal page, at the left hand side you will see selling tools, And under selling tools, you have seller preferences. Click on that. Now over here, you have this API access. Besides that, there is this link which says update. Click on that link. Now scroll down and you will see this option MVP, SOAP, API integration, classic. Select this thing. Under this, you have this link which says manage API credentials. Click on that link. Now you have your username, password, signature. Just make this thing show. Copy your username from here. Paste it over here. Similarly, make your password show and make your signature show. Copy and paste it over here. Now I cannot show that because this is all, you know, critical information, but you know, it is very simple. Just click on this show button just like this. Copy it from here. Paste it. Okay. Oh yes. Once you copy and paste everything, just click on save options. Now we have some more options after approval of payment. So once the payment is approved, what is the page that the user should go to? So you can select home page. After cancellation of payment process, again home page. Again click on save options. Now click on Stripe. Now here you have to put in the Stripe secret and publishable key. So this is also very easy. Go to stripe.com. Okay. Create an account. It is very simple to create an account. It will take few seconds. I have already created that. Now go to your dashboard. Okay, so this is my Stripe dashboard, as you can see over here. Now what I'll do is I'll click on APIs. Let's see, here it is. Okay, let me see, here it is under developers, I guess. Yeah, under developers, you have this API keys. Select this thing, and at present I am using this in the demo, in the test section. So this is only for text. Okay, let me see. I think this is the password. At present I am using the test data. As you can see here, it is at the test now. So whatever payment I make, it is only test. Okay, as you can see, live environment is off. So once I'm just, because I'm just creating a website for tutorial purposes, that's why I'm using test. So first is publishable key. Copy your publishable key from here, paste it under publishable key. Then we have secret key. Copy your secret key from here, paste it over here. Now once your website is live, make sure you make it live environment, and instead of this viewing test data, you just when you hover this, you have this activate your account link. Go to that link, activate your account. After that, you'll get two more coupons, two more keys, publishable and secret key, and that will be for live. Okay, so you can do that. Now at present my live environment is off. I have the secret key, publishable key. Now after successful payment, again I'll select home page. After failed payment, home page. Click on save options. Okay, now let's see a demo website of a demo tour of how our website is looking and how a user can sign up on your website and whether you get the payment. So let me open this website in an incognito window. Okay, so as you can see, this is how your website will look to a new user. And as you can see, instead of this login, well, instead of that, we are getting this login option. This login, we have register, we have to select the plan. We have created two plan, basic plan, premium plan. Let's see whether this happens or not. Let me select some username. Let me put in my email address. Okay. And let me select this plan, premium plan. Let's put in this text. Let's click on sign up. Okay, no, I didn't have to use PayPal actually. Okay, fine. Let's see what happens. At present, PayPal is selected. And as you can see, when you select PayPal, now you have been redirected to paypal.com. And here you have to put in your card information and everything. After that, you can make a payment. Okay, you can see the price over here is $50. Now let me come back. This was PayPal. Now let's see what happens when we select Stripe. So again, go to register. All the information are same. Okay. Use the premium thing and just instead of PayPal, select Stripe, click on sign up. Now, as you can see, we are not redirected. Okay. It says username or email already registered. So let me try again. Some different username and some different password. Maybe this one. Okay. Okay, so I have some different email address, different username. Select the premium plan, select the Stripe. Put in whatever you see over here. Okay, everything looks fine. Click on sign up. CAPTCHA failed. Okay, I think it is B, not E. Again, click on sign up. It is loading. Hopefully this time everything should be fine. Now, as you can see, we have this pop-up over here. Now we are not redirected to any third-party website like PayPal. And here it says test mode. Okay, so this is just test mode. Now let me see whether I am able to make a payment. Let's select. Okay, card number. I'll put in a demo card number. Don't try to act smart and use this card. This is just a demo card. Okay, don't fool yourself. Okay, so enter the card number, everything, click on pay $50. Let's see whether the payment is successful. Okay, it says the payment is successful. And now as you can see, after successful payment, we are redirected to the home page. Now let me see whether the payment, I have received that payment or not. So this is my dashboard. Okay, so this is my Stripe dashboard. Let me see. At the left hand side, you'll have this events, click on events. And here we have a successful payment was made for $50. Okay, you have all this information. Okay, so this is working. Okay, so this is how you accept payment. Now let us see a different thing. So we have added a payment. Now let's see whether we can create a new listing or not. So click on add new. Okay, first we'll have to log in, and to log in first we'll have to check in the email that we got on our mail address. So let me see that, because first we'll have to verify that this is our email address. Okay, so this is a very secure mode, a very professional website, as I said you earlier. Okay, let us see. Here we have your email address and password, username and password info. Okay, I think is this the one? Hopefully. Click on this. This is the username and we have to set our password. Let me set a new password. Okay, I think you can see this. So fine, click on reset password. Now again, I have to log in. The username is this, whatever username you have set, and password. Click on login. Okay, so here we have, now because I'm using the premium version, I can add offers, I can add items. So to add an item, I'll just hover items, click on add new, and I can add everything. So this is really amazing. Anyone can add, so user can add anything from here. Okay, if I had been if I had signed up with free plan, I would not see the special offers because that was not enabled, and I would see only two or three options over here, like content editor and so on. I would not see information like email and telephone. Okay guys, so with this I think we have completed the tutorial. I hope this tutorial was helpful, and I hope I have not missed anything. I hope this was a complete tutorial. I hope it helps you guys, and you guys can make some money using this. Now one more thing is left, I forgot. If you want to make money through Google AdWord, you can also do that. You just need to have an Google AdWord account. Okay, let me show you one thing. For example, let's first go to the, let's open this this single listing. Now first, obviously you must have a Google AdWord account. Now in the AdWord account you get some code, you all should know that. So what you have to do, you have at the left hand side, you have advertisements. Here it is, hover advertisements, click on add new. You can name it anything, for example add one. Okay, and you, if you have the image, you can create the image, or here you have the description. Now in the description, under this text section, just place that code, whatever that code you get. Okay, whatever the code you get from the Google, just paste it over here. So I won't paste that code, I'll just type in some simple text. This is a ad. Okay, now we can create a new category for this, add one, add new category. So make sure you put the Google text, the code that you get under this text section. Now click on publish. Now this is how your listing is looking. Now you can add this advertisement anywhere on this page. Okay, for example, if you want to add this advertisement, below this content or above this content, what you can do, you can click on page builder and you can select advertisements. Here it is. Let me first go, just drag it above content. Okay, display, yes, on which all category or which all category of the ad. So I'm selecting this category, open in new tab, it's all up to you. Click on OK, click on save options. Now if you think that this is only for one listing, no, if you select this thing, it will show on all the listings. Okay, let me show, let me go to the website first. Okay, let us open this listing first. We have created only one at present. Now as you can see here, it is showing this is a ad, as you can see. So this is working. So you can use this method to make some money as well. So you have two options, either use the packages one or use the ad one, or you can use both of them if you want. Okay, now this is how the ad will work. So this is working perfectly. Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. I hope it was helpful for you. If you guys enjoy it, make sure to subscribe to my channel and also click on that bell icon so that you don't miss future videos, any future videos. If you if this video has helped you, if you enjoy this video, make sure to give a thumbs up to this video. If you have any doubt, any questions, any query, any request for me, if you want me to make a certain kind of website for you, let me know in the comment section below. Okay guys, so I hope you have enjoyed it. Thanks a lot for watching guys. See you soon.